It's a little odd because I have no way to collectively refer to you guys. I used to say when last we saw our heroes, but that is becoming like decreasingly accurate. So I don't know.
The fuck
yeah, ones? Don't label us.
I guess in this game you guys are still vaguely heroic. Maybe. At any rate.
Don't label me.
After watching the mist form assistant conjure an increasingly large and none of them being useful series of wooden vessels from the ether and dropping them into a giant empty lake, you guys eventually decided he was not helpful and crossed via other means.
And I'm back.
Including but not limited to flight. And falling. Sometimes it's intentional. That's like if falling had a trademark, it'd be falling. Sometimes it's intentional. You then made it into... Well, whatever. you made it into the upper level of Talon Rest and found that it was full of these hobgoblin buttholes, which you proceeded to murder, as is the fashion.
And sexually violate.
I don't recall that part.
I do.
At least verbally violate.
There was that, yes.
That
there
happened.
Were trolls, too. There aren't any anymore. But there were trolls.
Of both kinds. Of them's
left.
There were a lot of boars. It seems like boars are kind of a thing here. And indeed, you discovered a spell of summon boar. So that's got to be good for something. Who knows what?
Summoning boars.
But
what's it going to say?
That's where you guys are at the moment, inside this cleared out level of Talonrest.
Percy searches the bookcase.
Searches the bookcase?
I search the bookcase I'm standing next to.
Okay.
Yep. I'm going to help him.
Give me an investigation. With advantage since you're being assisted.
Who has better investigation, me or you?
I can... Whatever.
What map are we supposed to be seeing?
I'm not using a map at this moment. There's no combat.
My investigation's 2, so I'm guessing yours is better.
No, mine's is 1.
Okay, so I'll do the investigating and you'll assist me.
Mine's is 1.
Can I inspire him too?
Man, if only one of us had high investigation.
Yeah, that'd be handy.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. So
I'm assisting person whoever said they were doing it.
I'll just let Boaz handle it. Boaz kind of like walked up, is like, shut up, push this aside, and started looking through the bookcase.
So you find not a lot of use. Most of these books are either quite boring or
ha ha ha.
Oh God! Oh no!
I thought that was a joke. I seriously thought that was a joke.
That was not intentional. I swear.
Wait, I don't get it.
Boring.
I swear that was not my intent.
Well then.
But that said, you do find a book that has had some pages torn out of it, and these pages are strewn across the surface, along with this spell book that you found last time, or rather this spell scroll. They appear to be a step-by-step process on how to butcher a boar.
Nice.
Or really just butchery of animals in general. followed by no less than a dozen recipes calling for boar. But aside from, you know, these sorts of materials, you don't find anything that seems terribly interesting.
Okay, I'll hand those to Percy. He's the cook.
Too many cooks.
Too many books.
Yep, too many books.
You said none of those books were terribly interesting?
I mean, there's all kinds of stuff here. You could, if you want, you could spend a very long time digging through each book individually. I could give you some titles as you just, like, browse the spines. But you, what you're finding is a mixture of, like, practical guides, mostly in the area of, like, butchering, I guess, and recipe books. But that said, going down a couple of titles, let me see. There's one titled The Final Bridge.
Okay.
That seems interesting to our situation.
Titled The Stranger's Gift.
That also...
These are the ones that aren't covered by the stuff I was just telling you about.
Okay. You said that second one is The Stranger's Gift?
No. It's a shocker.
God damn it, wait! I don't know if that was intentional, but god damn it.
That was very intentional.
And then there is a book titled Last Sanctuary.
Yeah.
All three of these have words in them that make me think they're important.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to grab up these three.
But I may be drunk.
It is up to you as to whether you find these important and want to read them.
I would like to take a look at the Sanctuary book, because I have a shield by that name.
Okay.
Shmendrick with the shield.
Yeah.
So, pulling it out of the bookshelf, dislodging some dust, this section appears not to have interested the goblin shaman who used to call this room home. Blowing off the dust. There is, in fact, an emblem of a shield on the cover.
I guess I'll, if no one minds, I'll take the book and read it next time we have a rest or something.
Okay.
Sounds good. I wouldn't mind browsing through it later, but you could probably just tell me.
Does the shield on the cover react to the presence of the cleric?
No.
Aye. And I'll grab up the other two bridge or the other two books to look through. Is the Final Bridge and the Stranger's Gift, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I'll grab those two. I'll throw those in my bag.
Okay. Are you guys doing anything with these at the moment, or are you just storing them?
I think we're just storing them for now.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just going to store it.
Okay. So, at this point, you know that you have seen this entire floor. It's pretty gross. It's in a pretty bad state. This place is obviously going to take some work to bring up to, like, the standards of a place people would want to, you know, live in or study in or whatever. But it appears well-built and highly defensible. You know that there's a staircase leading downward. Or there's the door you came in. Also, each of these five sort of turrets, I guess they're towers, technically speaking, has a small balcony that wraps around the outside.
Hmm.
And they're all elevated quite a ways above the surface of the earth below, this cracked kind of floodplain looking terrain. And you do notice as well that there is a ridge along the lip of this cliff, whatever that would be called, the edge of the cliff, where the land rises up. And there seems to be some exposed bedrock there.
Hmm.
Right where this castle is actually built.
Hmm. That all still, sounds pretty dangerous.
It's still quite a ways down. So the deepest part, it's like 50 feet straight down.
Okay.
And through a window to the south on this map, which is actually north. Oh, you're not looking at the map anymore. but, you know, the way you saw it before, you had been going, like, up, right? Up on the page. That direction mm-hmm. was south. So to the north, through a window that is open, you can see ships appearing in midair and then falling.
Oh, God.
And there is a growing pile of splintered wood.
So?
Somebody blue screened.
Shall we continue?
Who ripped? What?
Oh, also, Conti, I need to know what you're doing with the thing. I think it was Conti who had it.
Which thing?
I think there's four things.
There's
actually.
Lots of things.
The thing that was weird.
That I don't have the thing that's weird.
Asked about.
That's 808.
Somebody asked me about a weird thing, and then I did something with the weird thing. I don't have it on me.
You don't have it on you. What did you do with it?
I stashed the weird thing.
Where?
In the other room where we found it.
Okay. Cool. Great.
Good like Indiana Jones style. You know, top men.
Did any of us...
Right. Okay, sure. Cool.
I don't even know about it.
Stash. All right, never mind. Sorry.
Yeah, I don't know where he stashed it. I know he stashed it. I don't know where. Well, I don't even know that he stashed it. I know that he took it. But that's it. Nobody else should know that he stashed it.
I'm being out of character.
Nobody should know that it exists.
Out of character, yeah, nobody should know it even exists. And also out of character, I'm coming back to go get it later. It's like something we got to come back to look at.
Yeah.
It seemed a little too like fragile to fuck with if like things are attacking us.
So you guys want to go down these stairs or what?
That's what I was gonna do, probably.
Sounds like a plan to me.
We're still on the map, right? Of Talon Rest and the picture of the
I mean that is the building you're in. I don't have the map up because you guys aren't in combat. So as you head down the stairs, you pass behind these piles of boxes arranged in kind of a peculiar way and skirt around the cooking fire that has been reduced to ash at this point. Step over a few hobgoblin bodies. You head down the stairs and... As you do, you see that it is very, very dark on the second floor, the second from the top. Not unnaturally dark, just totally unlit.
Time to light up our lives with a light spell.
Okay. Wow. As your magic light floods into the room, you see that the layout of the floor is similar to the floor above, but some of the peripheral rooms are closed off. But there is a terrible smell in here
Like a decaying boar smell or something else?
Some it could be boar. It's, you know, it's refuse, essentially. You can't really identify it just from looking at it, but it doesn't look great, and it really doesn't smell great. And slowly but surely, you guys work your way down through the floors of this building. Most of them are just totally empty. It seems like these hobgoblins you encountered at the top were actually the only ones still living in here. But eventually the staircase ends after, let me see here. Six floors. And you find yourselves in a great hall with a long wooden table. And about an inch of stagnant water covering the entire floor.
Ew.
Yeah.
And it smells like mold and rot.
Cover your nose, Gary.
Unlike the other floors, however, this one... actually... could somebody give me a perception check?
Sure.
You guys decide who's gonna run that.
I got it.
Okay. All right. Never mind. You guys don't notice anything else.
Oh, okay.
So there's a very long table that has some kind of cloth runner down the top of it, and it appears to be set for like a meal service. There are chairs running down both sides, and at the end there are three very large, presumably once very fancy, like wooden thrones, essentially.
No.
But the plates are empty.
I'm gonna run up and sit on one of the thrones.
Okay. As you run through the long room, your feet sloshing in the inch deep, nasty, brackish water.
Ugh.
Get down to the other end, and you see that the thrones. Actually, like all of the chairs upon closer inspection, many of them are kind of tilted at weird angles.
Uh-huh.
Just very slight, but like somebody didn't make the legs the right length or something.
It's weird.
Freaking hobgoblins.
But these are not poorly made chairs. They're exquisitely made.
They're just uneven?
Yeah, they just for some reason are tilted at very slightly odd angles.
I'm going to examine the chairs for magical properties.
Okay,
after you sit on it.
While I'm sitting on it.
As far as while you can tell, nothing in this room is magic.
Outside of what the party arose. Yeah.
Yeah, I suppose the only things you would actually find out about are the chairs. But as you're examining them, looking at these chairs, you can see that the bases of the legs are actually swollen. Probably from having absorbed water.
Oh, so that's why they're uneven is basically rot.
But you sit in, which chair do you sit in at the end?
You said there were three, right?
Yeah, there's three thrones. The only thing that, you're operating on dark vision at this point, so you can't tell anything. Well, you can tell that one of them is black, and one of them is white, and one of them looks gray. Like the, set, the cloth.
Sit on the white one.
Okay. Yeah. Racist. A plume of dust erupts around you.
That was some loud dust.
Farted.
Poof. It probably sounded better here than over the microphone.
Surprised it made any noise at all, actually.
He jumped up into the chair.
Oh, he jumped
landed on it. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's, I mean, it's chair meant for bird people, and it's
at least I that's how I interpreted what he said.
I thought he sat down, and the dust went.
No. I was interpreting him as him jumping into the chair, but maybe I was, yeah. You know, that's in my brain. That's what it
was. I think that's how we all were seeing Boaz jump into
so
a chair.
He was so enthusiastic about it, I assume.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Like a kid in a fucking
chair. At any rate, the chair appears to be quite dusty. Nothing happens.
You catch
it
emphysema.
Smells bad.
Is there anything else of interest in this room? Or is there anything, like, any kind of other markings on the walls or anything like that?
Make a perception check.
Another one. Hopefully this is better.
So slightly. You notice near the stairwell, where the stairwell lands, there is a...
Dusty. Now, like, him coughing,
oh,
and I said
dust.
Dusty.
There is a... How did I describe this? It's like... a metal protrusion from the wall that comes down at an angle, kind of like a torch bracket.
Okay. It just looks like
a... You also notice...
Okay.
Sorry, I'm trying to think of what you would see based on where you are and,
okay.
and what you rolled. You also, as you're sloshing around in this water, you kick something with your foot.
Oh. Let's see what that is.
It looks like a rib bone. Quite
large. Ouch. Quite large, like larger than a humanoid?
Too big to be human.
Okay, so possibly like troll type situation?
Could be.
Okay. Well, there's that. We've already encountered trolls and hobgoblins, so it's nothing terribly unexpected. The fact that it's bones and not alive like the rest, it's kind of odd. Means there was something big enough to kill it, or it got trapped.
How old does the bone look?
Is it still fleshy, or...?
It is... Well, it's wet.
It's wet.
It was underwater.
Yeah.
Which makes it hard to tell how old it is.
Those are still...
Apparently not old enough to have rotted.
Yeah.
Is there still...
Like, rotted
any type of meat left on it, or is it just bone?
There's no visible meat.
Okay.
No flesh. Yeah, so aside from that, all you find is the strangely upside-down torch bracket. Basically.
Do I see it?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to...
Actually, I guess I should point out that in addition to this, there are columns around the outside of the room. You know, basically any room with a stone roof is going to have columns to support it.
Yeah.
And there are regular-looking torch brackets at even intervals. None of them have torches in them.
I'm gonna say to the party, it's like, I think this was supposed to be right side up, but I don't know what's going to happen when I turn it right side up. How about I actually think about this for once and not actually just do it? How about you guys get out of the room, at least just at the doorway, so at least if somebody's gonna get trapped in here, it's only one of us. Unless somebody wants to be trapped.
No,
yeah.
I'll hang here with you.
You'll be in here with me?
Yeah,
okay.
Because, okay, worst case scenario, if we get trapped in here, I can both get us out of here.
Yeah, I'm leaving the room. Later.
Okay, I'm cool with that. You have that dimension doors, yeah. Some situation like that? Okay.
I could dimension doors out of here.
I like that idea. I hadn't thought of an escape plan. So, all right. So is everybody except for me and Percy out?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Okay. So I'm going to try to. I'm going to flip that torch holder right way up.
Okay. So you touch this metal protrusion. And it has like a small ring on the end, like one that would be used to hold a torch, but it's, now that you think about it, it's actually too small for that. But as you go to turn it up, it actually just kind of levers straight up.
Yeah, okay. And so it was a lever.
As it flips up into position, you hear a click. And could you remind me real quick which books you took?
I have on me I have The Final Bridge, mm-hmm. and The Stranger's Gift. Schmendrick has Last Sanctuary.
Got it. Okay. That was totally irrelevant. I just wanted to take the note down and create a little tension. So thanks, John. As it clicks into place, you see a stone from the wall to the left of it, like basically dead center in the stairwell landing, slide inward. And several other stones slide inward with it. And you can actually see all around the room, there are these patches of stones that are sliding inward. What do you do?
I mean,
like a couple inches.
Like the room is shrinking?
So they are regularly spaced. What was that sound? No, something wrong with my computer. They are regularly spaced rectangular patches of stone that are sliding inward about an inch and a half, let's say, at this point.
Sliding in towards the middle of the room?
Yes. Although, okay. Again, only a tiny amount.
Yeah, not the whole walls, just... But...
Right. As opposed to, we're trying to figure out if they're going inwards or outwards.
They're going inward.
Well, yeah, I meant like what you meant by inwards. I could interpret the word being into the room or into the wall.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. So.
Sorry. Toward the center of the room.
Okay. How big's the gap in between, roughly? Like,
it is between what?
Between where these...
The sections.
Are they staggered?
So each patch of stone is about 2 feet thick. Wide and 4 feet tall. They are spaced about in the main hall, because there's one right next to you. But in the rest of the hall, they are spaced about 10 feet apart. Maybe a little
more. But they don't go all the way to the roof?
No.
Okay.
They sort of start at like chest height and then go up a bit. Maybe a little lower than that.
Continue watching?
Do you move? Do you stay where you are?
I'm going to be ready.
Like
I'm going
a
to
split
be...
second to react.
Yeah. I'm going to be ready to duck if I need a duck.
Yep.
Okay.
I'm going to be right. ready to teleport us. I'm going to start getting ready to dimension door us out the fucking room.
Okay, so staying on that floor, you tense and get ready to react to whatever is happening right now. The stones continue sliding in until they have slid in about a foot, and then they slide. Each patch divides itself in half into two, like, vertical strips. Mm-hmm. And as this happens, you see light flood into the room from all directions. Which takes a moment to adjust to it. And then what you're looking at are a bunch of brilliantly lit stained glass windows that have revealed themselves.
Oh, cool.
Cool.
Including the one right next to you, which is not entirely stained. It has like a ornamentation around the outside in colors you could probably guess. at this point. But most of the window is just a grid of clear panes with a bevel. And looking out, you can actually see down onto the town of McGillicuddy.
I'm guessing at this point, well, we can hear all this, like, architectural movement, right, from outside.
Yeah, you basically hear stones grinding.
Yeah. I'm going to open a door and come back in. Or
yep, it's look. Safe. It seems safe. Safe enough. We're not dead yet, so. It opened the windows, essentially.
You can't prove that.
So with this perceived now, to be fine. With this bright light flooding the room, you can now see the disgusting scene in all its glory. The mold climbing up the inside of the walls. This rancid looking water that is not clear. It is the opposite of clear. It looks like somebody drained a swamp and then just poured it into this room.
I just imagine it looks like it smells.
Lovely, like opulent rosewood furniture just
ruined,
destroyed by the water. It's like an advertisement for like a flood cleanup service, you know? And then at the end of it are these three, at the end of this table there are the three thrones, with Boaz sitting on the one in the middle with the white cushions.
Well, Boaz left the room previously.
Oh, right. Sorry. Never mind. I forgot he wasn't still there.
Yeah.
So in the middle is the one with the white cushions, and then on the left and the right are the red and black cushions.
Okay. All right. Well, at least the room's lit. It still smells horrible.
You also hear another click at this point, now that the windows are done opening. And the water starts to move toward the stairwell. As the stones beneath your feet, because you're standing at the base of the stairwell, start to move downward.
Oh, take some steps back off that.
Okay. As you take a couple steps back, it drops down, and the stones furthest from the landing drop the farthest, and you see that they have dropped into a pattern of stairs, descending one more level down.
I did not move. I just stood there.
Some of the water floods into this new space. So the floor is now essentially just wet instead of like a pool. Of shallow
getting there.
And as this is happening, you see that the stair that drops the furthest has revealed a door.
Hmm. All right. Who wants to do the honors?
Ah, fuck it, I will.
I was like, you're the thief.
Have I said I'm a thief? I kind of am.
I'd like to cast a spell.
Oh, God.
Okay.
I cast Prestidigitation to make it smell like cinnamon rolls in the room.
Nice.
I threw up.
It now smells like mold and cinnamon rolls.
I don't notice.
It's true.
Even more dank. Reminds me of Cinnabon.
It's dank.
God damn it.
Sorry, it reminds me of the closed down Cinnabon.
Either way. Alright, well, I guess I'll open the door. Or attempt to. I don't know if it's locked.
You're not sure how to open this door. So you've seen this door from the other side. It is basically a stone door that you know raises up. But there's no handle on it anywhere. It just has this symbol on it.
So have we basically come around the circle then? We're back in that little place or on the opposite side?
It seems like you might be standing on the door that is on the opposite side. You might be standing on the opposite side of the door that you opened before. Potentially. Or a door that looks the same. Maybe this place has a lot of those doors, although this is the only one you've seen.
And remind me, what was on the what symbol was on the door? Just the symbol of the talons, or?
Excellent question. So the symbol on the door is the symbol associated with the doves.
Okay.
Nope, sorry, wrong one. the ravens.
Okay.
Yes.
So we've seen this symbol a lot here. What's this? What the fuck does it mean?
It's one faction of the Talons. They were kind of a judge, jury, and executioner type.
I'm sorry, I jumped ahead of my notes. This is actually the... This one would actually just have the, like, Talon symbol on it.
Oh, okay. So
the inverted Y with the extra leg. Sorry about that.
Okay, so disagree what I said.
Yeah, I should have recognized these better.
Yeah. Well, I guess you would still be seeing this symbol around, so maybe not disagree what I said.
And I would still say death.
Well, I mean, if you manage to get to the executioner part, yeah. But
I have no idea what it means. I'd still say death.
You know that they shot down our boat a while back.
I may or may not.
Well, not our boat, but that dragon's boat. When you first met, first adventure.
But that was my only run-in with them.
True. Is Aru still here?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, you just dropped out of the game.
That's correct.
Yeah. Restarting it.
I did so intentionally.
Yep. Just wanted to make sure that you weren't lagging out or something.
No, I'm here.
Okay.
So how do you guys think we should open this door? Is on this side of it, is there any like weird protrusions on it, or is like the symbol have like an extra bit of outline on it?
How so at this point you only kind of got a brief glimpse of it, because at this point that part of the stairwell where the door is has flooded with this brackish water.
Oh.
So you wouldn't really have time to examine it in depth.
Okay, so I thought the water had like drained out somewhere else.
No, it has flowed down basically into the place you have to go to continue down.
Well, up to that point, is there anything on the walls by chance?
No.
No, there's
nothing catches your notice.
Wait, so we know there's a door there, but we can't see anything?
Is that you saw that as it was, as the stairs were dropping down, the water was still pouring in. You saw that there was a stone door with the symbol of the talons on it. But after the stones finished dropping down, the water finished flooding it. And so now you can't see it anymore. You know it's down there.
I think I might actually be underwater right now. I didn't move.
He so stayed on the steps.
From your perspective, what happened was you just descended down in front of this door, and then the water filled in around you. You see, let's see, with blind sight, you see this shape of this inverted Y with the extra leg. And around the edge, there are smaller symbols carved into a border.
Oh, and these are like door opening mechanics?
Mm.
Okay. Does it have a handle?
No.
Rip.
The only reason I'm calling it a door is because you saw something that looked like this before, and it opened.
I'm going to touch the shield to the stone door thing we have up here.
The shield?
The one that we found.
Okay.
I'm going to like tap it against a stone, I guess.
So you reach the shield down into the water and against the stone. Nothing happens.
I'll say the shield's name, Sanctuary, in a commanding voice.
Oh, interesting. Okay. As you say the name of the shield, you all find yourselves standing in the middle of a city. There is... Hang on. Wow. Okay, I wasn't expecting this to happen at this
point. This is nice.
A dimension no, door not. Back.
That's not how that works. So, you find yourselves standing in the middle of the city, and you hear a roar, and looking up above you, there is a black dragon that is spraying this green blast of some kind of acidic substance down onto the buildings. You see them just spontaneously exploding into fire. All around you, your fellow Knights of Ardis are fighting the invading Orcish Horde.
Do we all see this or just him?
You all see this.
I'm going to grab the shield again and say, not Sanctuary.
So
do the jingle. Do the jingle.
Lifting your arm, you see that the shield is no longer on it. In fact, you see the commander of your phalanx to the left wielding this shield above him. And you see that the battle has gotten to the point where the enemy has overrun the walls. A flaming boulder hurled by a trebuchet crashes into a nearby building, sending flinders in all directions. This sea of green tusked assailants are past the walls. You see the gatehouse burning in the distance.
Where's my boar? Is he with us?
I imagine that you are actually probably having the weirdest time right now.
Oh.
Because you're not used to seeing color. And you're also not used to being a human.
Which
is what all of you are. No, you are yourselves. Looking down, you see that you are in completely unfamiliar forms.
I feel
all
shorter.
Wearing this shining silver plate.
What? I'm so tall.
I got an armor upgrade, but I lost my fucking tail. Where's my tail?
Do I experience syndrome with my diving bell?
Yes. I don't know.
Hey, John.
That's up to you. That's a character decision, I guess.
What? Do we still recognize one another in these different forms, or are we all unrecognizable? Okay.
Each of you sees this same scene.
Do we recognize the other people as the people that they are? Like we've inherited their memories and acquaintances?
Give me an insight check as you think about that.
Would you like me to roll one as well, given I've asked?
I have pushed the button.
Yeah, whoever
wanting to respond.
Whoever is trying to you're having enough trouble just adapting to the idea of being made of meat. that you're not sure what it would even mean. Shmendrick, you know you know that your name is Percival.
Copycat.
Is that a name I should recognize?
You know that you were originally... give me a history check, actually. You know that you were originally drafted into a militia that through the dire straits of the situation you now find yourself in got conglomerated into this army. And while at first you were very uncertain and wanted nothing more than to go back to your farm, at this point you know, you have fought with these other warriors, and you would lay down your life for them. And you might have to.
Do I have any insights?
Insight.
You're 21. Not a gnome.
Yeah. your name is James.
Okay.
Before this, you were a faithful cleric, and you've never, before joining this force, you had never been outside the monastery. And since then, you've had to do unspeakable things. Things that you're not sure you could ever be forgiven for.
Definitely butt sex.
Surprise,
Boaz. Give me a history check, Boaz.
Okay.
I would like to see if my junk's still in the same place and is still the same gender.
Oh, wow.
Where's my fucking tail?
What tail? That's why I've never had a tail.
I'm sorry. What was that last?
He's making sure he's still the same gender.
Who was? I lost track.
Percy.
No.
The real Percy.
I have tits. It's fucking great.
Oh god. Yes, but they are of course currently on the other side of a, you know, an accurate and actually defensive.
Yeah, not a tit plate, an actual proper, like, I wouldn't die if,
like,
I got hit. Yeah,
real, yeah, warrior's armor.
And they're bound.
So, and Boaz, you recognize this, and actually all of you at this point notice that the symbol on your armor is the Talon Rest sigil.
Why did you have me make a history check?
Because, Boaz, you know what this is.
Oh, okay.
You recognize this place. You know when this happened. This was hundreds of years ago. And this is a battle that is regarded as myth. The way the story is told can't be true. The way it ends is impossible. But you're about to witness it.
Do I have a weapon?
Yes. You have a longsword.
Okay, I'm gonna lift my longsword in the air and say, "Dile, dile!"
So
there's Boaz.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Can I try and cast? Can I try and cast Minor Illusion?
Can paladins of the ninth level cast that spell?
Probably.
Minor Illusion? I don't.
If so, then no, yes.
Maybe not then. Yeah, I was like, I'm gonna try and cast one of my cantrips. See what happens. Nope.
So, around you, you see this green, I'm trying not to say the words green flame. You see this green flame raining down from above, and this hail of arrow fire, and Saint Artis holds his shield above him and says, "Give me space to you." What do you guys do?
Definitely do.
You're about to be overrun.
Yes.
Yeah,
probably a good idea.
Well, what would entire, like, giving him space, would that be running toward the enemy?
So they are closing in all directions.
Oh, or surrounded.
But primarily from the direction of the gatehouse.
Yeah, but where is he in terms compared
He's
to?
He's in the center of town, along with the rest of you.
Oh,
you're not far apart. You were all fighting back to back up until this moment.
But he tells us to give him space.
Yeah.
Yeah, I back the fuck up.
Okay.
I guess I'll just, like, shout at everyone to do what the man said.
My nipples are chafing.
Dilly dilly.
He holds the shield above himself, and you see the runes around the perimeter ignite with this radiant energy. And he says, "Gods grant me sanctuary." And there's silence that washes over the battlefield. And a moment that stands still. And then there's an explosion of radiant energy from his position that washes out and expands and covers the entire city. It passes harmlessly through you, but as it passes through the orcish horde, they are physically lifted and thrown so high into the air that you can't even resolve them as bodies. As you see them fly back over the walls, scattered on the battlegrounds beyond. In the other room, there is currently a cat that is very angry because of a raccoon or something.
I heard it.
That's awesome.
Damn it, Ernie. So he's not freaking out.
Could be the sound of battle.
Hang on, I'll be right
there. Yeah, capitalist records.
No problem.
Well, I was not expecting all this.
No.
Cartilage is weird.
What?
Cartilage is weird.
He has flesh and joints and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Context. Yep, I understand now.
But I mean, even in general, it is weird, you know?
Yeah.
So there's, like, this crazy situation going on, and there's, like, just a soldier poking at his nose.
Like, poking it left and right, like...
pulling on his ears.
Like flicking his earlobes.
Bending his knees and his arms.
What?
And I'm not joking, I'm pretty sure my nipples are chafed. It's not funny.
What are you guys talking about? I just got that.
Cartilage being weird and nipple chafing.
Alright, anyway, sorry. So, it was like the most annoying time for that to happen. Yeah. So, this bubble of radiant force throwing back, physically, literally throwing back the invading force, you see this green fire raking harmlessly against the surface of the bubble as it expands to cover the entire city.
Bubble.
And hail of arrows bouncing off of it. And as they do, they glimmer for a moment in the air before disappearing. And all this time, the intensity of the light that Saint Artis is glowing with has transformed him into a white, bright white silhouette. And all you see is the shield shining with this energy. And then it vanishes. And there's a quiet moment. And he raises his hand and points one finger at the dragon above and annihilates it. This beam of radiant energy shoots out of him and the dragon vaporizes.
That 20th level guiding bolt, yo.
Yeah.
Must be a homebrew class.
And as this happens, the energy of that now forms the saint's body fades, and the shield clatters to the floor. And then a moment later, it too vanishes. But this battle that appeared completely lost is now a total rout as your forces rally and rush back out of the gates and destroy the few remaining forces of the enemy. And then you are back.
Oh, cool.
Standing in this room, holding this shield.
Oh, thank God, my tail's back.
Alton turns.
Yes, yes, you are all who you were, but you all had that little experience.
I'm slightly disappointed.
Is the
and with this, Shrendrick, you gain the knowledge of what Sanctuary is and how it works. So Sanctuary is a shield, which means it grants you +2 AC when you're wielding it. It functions like adamantine armor. So as long as you are wielding it, critical hits count as regular hits against you.
Wow. And
on top of that, once, and only once, for a cleric or paladin of good or neutrality. This is mechanics translation of one sufficiently devoted to, you know, blah. Can invoke Sanctuary by using a reaction and speaking the phrase, "Gods grant me Sanctuary." And speaking the name of the shield was sufficient to trigger this memory of the last time it was used.
Good thing I didn't use those other words.
Yeah, that would have been really unfortunate. So what happens when it's used is it creates a bubble of radiant force that expands outward, dealing a tremendous amount of damage, which we can get into when and if this ever comes up, to specifically unaligned creatures, so things that are not your allies in some way. And for 1 minute, it absorbs all incoming damage within a 1 mile radius. At
Jesus
the end of that minute,
Christ.
At the end of that minute, it deals all that damage to you.
Oh.
And one target of your choice.
Oh, shit.
Fucking kamikaze.
So, yeah. That's what it is.
Suicide bomber.
The shield then vanishes into the celestial realm and returns to the world in a couple centuries.
Okay, then.
So you guys just, you know, store that wherever you want.
Yeah, you can hang on to that.
But
there,
one thing it doesn't do is open doors. So the door is still closed.
Oh, I guess I have a spell that opens doors.
Kind of. It doesn't open doors so much as unlock doors.
Oh, that's true. I've made that mistake before.
Yeah, so the last time you tried to use it on a door in this building, the door became unlocked, but because there was no handle and it weighed like a ton, there was pretty much no way to open it, so.
Yeah.
Because the door had to be lifted. Mm-hmm. Of course, this one might work differently. You never know.
Is there anything back up in the other room? Any other ways out? Or is the only way out of that other room either the way we came in or straight down?
As far as you know, this is the only way out. Aside from going all the way back up and then, I don't know, rappelling down the cliff or something.
Go ahead.
From your position in the stairwell, you would also notice light spilling above. And for simplicity's sake, every landing of the stairwell has one of these windows that has opened. Sorry, what were you saying?
Isn't there like a little phrase or thing to open the front door? Maybe that could help here.
I was wondering if you guys wanted me to try that.
You go do that. I will be right back.
Okay. Sure, I'll say that phrase in Irian. Black of night, blood of red, bone of white.
Okay. The door slides down. And the water follows it.
All right.
Did I hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you hear stone sliding, followed by water flowing.
Oh, never mind. I come back.
Okay. so there are now some pretty slick stones to continue downward. But you guys are able to make your way down into a room that branches into three paths. It looks very similar to the arrangement from the main hall of this place.
Mm-hmm.
So it branches into three doorways.
Oh, so this didn't go back around. This is a new area.
Yeah, it actually looks exactly like the bottom floor, and based on what you saw out the window, it seems like this should be inside the hall, but you clearly aren't. Something isn't quite lining up spatially.
I'm going to go to the door on the left and try to open it.
Okay. So yeah, as you get to the bottom of the stairs, and there is this drop downward about 5 feet into which the water has now pooled, although it's only filling the bottom. Let's see. Based on the size of the floor above, probably the bottom foot at this point. And the doors at the ends of each of these hallways are like at nose level, essentially. Like that's where the bottom of the door is. 5 feet off the ground. Whatever that is for you. You're all different heights.
Yeah. So, judging by what we knew before, which way would be the direction towards the main door?
Each one has a symbol. So each one has a symbol for one of the three different branches. So you see one is the raven, one is the dove, and one is the...
I'm actually going to make my cardinals statement, and I'm going to go to the... Well, no, I don't know what the symbols are yet.
Yeah, I was going to say cardinal, because the red one, that would make the most sense.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a cardinal, but I'm going to call it a cardinal because it's, you know... Easy. I can't really think of another,
red
like,
chicken.
A bird that is known as being red.
Chicken.
Yeah. Chicken.
Cornish hen.
No, like red.
Yeah, like Cornish hens.
Yeah, they're like orange red.
Cardinal's better.
Yeah. Like blood red.
Flamingo.
No.
So I'm going to real quick ask about the three symbols here, and they're going to explain to me that it's the thing, the thing, and the thing.
Yeah, presumably. Sure.
Presumably.
Yeah, I'll give them.
They can tell you nothing, and the stranger ignores you. Oh, good. Just who I wanted to play D&D with, the mysterious stranger who doesn't want to go on an adventure. Sorry. Anyway.
I'm going to amend my previous statement of the door on the left and go to the door with the raven symbol.
Okay.
And
The doors are about chest height for me, I think. My character's 6'8".
So the bottom of the door is 5 feet off the ground. I'll just put it
right. So that's what I mean, is it's like chest height. So if there's a doorknob, I should be able to reach up and.
There is no doorknob. These are flat stone
slates
with a trim of runes around the outside edge, and a single large rune in the center that identifies which branch of the organization.
Who designed this place?
I don't know. Somebody who likes Tiefling. Labyrinths.
Can you open this door?
Make an architectural history check. There's no such thing.
It's a history check. Architecture.
So Percy, you are very sure that no history book speaks of who designed this place.
That's actually significant.
Yep. No contractor in their right mind would have taken this job.
Actually, I guess Talon Rest isn't totally unknown. You know what? Sure. So you don't know about the actual construction of this place, but you know that it is rumored to defy space and time.
As proven before with a little trial to get to patients the first time.
Bigger on the inside.
Well, and with this new thought, you know, thinking back to that last room you were in, how could it have windows all the way around it? Wasn't it embedded inside a cliff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's a TARDIS. Awesome.
In a weird way. God, man.
Anyways, hey, Tiefling, can you open this door?
Maybe.
Just identifying people by shouting, "Hey, race!"
Yeah, it's Conti, by the
way. Names.
It's Conti, by the way, John, what the runes around the edge? Do they say anything particular that I would know?
They are not in Irian.
Okay.
Can I read them?
Yeah, it's like, can any of you guys read the runes before I start spouting anything in a weird language?
Unless it's in Celestial or Common, I can't.
Yeah. Boaz, Schmendrick.
This does not appear to be a language.
They're just runes. I think we determined that before, actually. Is they're just weird runes.
Yeah, so Boaz would probably have the best luck with this. You would recognize them as magical runes. Putting it in terms like modern, you know, reality terms, it's kind of more like a programming language than anything else. Although it's really not that either.
As long as it's not HTML.
Or like math or symbolic logic or something like that, you know? Like, it's not a representation of natural language. It's a representation of arcane concepts.
Can I go up to one of the doors and then put my hand up against one of the runes and then just... Will it
sure,
open?
Which one?
I don't know. Somebody pick one.
Wait a minute.
I'm gonna try something.
Conti, where are you standing?
I'm still standing in the doorway with that. Yeah, above where this pool of water is, because I don't feel like jumping into it right yet.
I see. So you haven't actually gone down into these and seen the three doors yet.
Well, I mean, I could probably see them.
You could see the one across from you.
Yeah. Oh, so I can't
like
look
cross,
around. I can't.
It's like a cross junction. So no.
Oh, I can't
You're at one end of the cross junction. It's not an X intersection, and you're at
like
the far
X,
end of the street.
You would have to walk to the center. It's just like main hall.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're not in the four way. You're at the end of one of the four ways.
Correct.
Okay.
I don't care how you open it. Just someone open this fucking door.
Why that? Whatever. Percy was.
Are you saying
Percy's
character?
Yes.
Can I find out if he has any alternative motives? I don't think he does, but can I find out if he has any
insight check, I guess?
Yeah. Because it's like, that's... That seems really suspicious. I don't think it's anything actually in character, but it seems really suspicious, so...
Feel free to contest that with deception or persuasion, whatever you think is more appropriate.
Hey, Conti.
What?
You would have noticed in combat when I cast my spells, I have a fucking raven feather tattooed on my right hand that glows.
I wasn't anywhere near you when you cast your spells.
You have been.
He isn't paying attention.
Oh, that's true. You do have that.
I haven't been. Well, no, I all
so,
the. I don't think any of the fighting that you've been in, I've been near, actually.
I've cast spells around you.
Oh, I don't remember. I didn't notice it. So.
At least I think in the tavern, I cast Control Water to put out the flame that Boaz started.
So, hang on. Did you touch the Raven door?
I imagine I would have in attempting to see if there was a doorknob somewhere.
Okay. Make a Constitution saving throw.
So there is something to my insight check. Wow! Nice. There you go.
So as you lay your hand on this stone surface, you feel this wave of nausea run through you. And it you're able to resist it effortlessly and push yourself back from it, and it turns your stomach, but you manage to keep it together. This door to you registers as profoundly unholy.
Mm. Even more so, someone opened this fucking door.
did my insight check? Well, he hasn't contested it yet. So
there's nothing to contest. You were asking, and you asked for insight. There's a raven feather tattooed on his right hand.
I mean, that'd be perception.
I can't see you where I'm at.
Well, in insight, I imagine he would have noticed a glowing raven feather on my hand at some point.
Yeah, but he's not there. You're like around the
that
corner.
That would be a perception check. Insight is for understanding people's motivations and things like that.
Well,
yeah, I can't see you.
I mean previously, not currently. Previously, you've seen me cast magic. You've seen me cast spells, and I have to invoke my holy symbol, which is tattooed on the back of my hand.
I think we had a conversation.
Really sure. So here's the thing. To me, it's not even obvious what the connection is here. So I think you might be operating on some character knowledge that he doesn't have.
Yeah. And it's not like, I don't even know. I don't think Conti would even care.
I mean, I picked up on something there. Like I see what, I think I see what you're doing now, but I can see why Conti is not getting what you're talking about.
Yeah. Plus so like
I
most of the time,
be obvious necessarily.
Yeah. Plus most of the time, like, I wouldn't. It would be pretty hard to pick up that up, a glowing symbol on you, because I like, in the tavern is the only time I would have been able to perceive it, because all the other time, anyway.
Let's resolve this. Okay. So, if you're choosing not to contest it, then he just passes.
Yeah,
I'm not contesting it.
Yeah. So,
there's a raven symbol on the door, and I have a raven feather. My deity is the Raven Mother.
Yeah, so you suss out that there might be some connection there.
Okay.
I'm going to the red door.
You walk up to the door with the red inlaid runes around the edges.
I'm going
to
touch the runes. And I'm literally just going to... I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm literally just gonna touch the runes. I'm just gonna like will it open.
Did you see, Altum? Did you see what happened? I'm getting used to the new name now.
Did I see what happened
to
him?
Altum? Yeah.
Probably.
Okay. So you're kind of ready for it then.
Yeah.
In that case, you touch the door, kind of expecting the worst. You hear. You hear a sound. Specifically, hang on, stand by. You hear this sound. No one else hears this.
What the heck?
Who ripped ass?
Like a war horn.
Yeah.
And in fact, you also hear the clashing of steel, and something explodes behind you, and you turn instinctively to shield your eyes, and nothing is happening. But the sounds of battle are still ringing in your ears.
You're never too old for a Vietnam flashback.
I know, right?
Too young.
I was like, it's too young.
Okay.
Shut up.
I'm going to hop still down from where I'm at. I'm going to walk over to Percy.
Am I still hearing it?
As soon as your fingers lift from the surface, you don't hear it anymore.
I'm going to touch it again. Like with one finger.
You hear the sounds of battle.
And like, you know, like on off.
And as you touch it, you also feel your heart racing and you feel yourself getting like exhausted with the effort of fighting in this pitched conflict. And you start to see flashes of light around you as your vision narrows to a tunnel. What do you do?
That's weird. I found something.
Okay, I want
from the door.
What?
Are you removing your hand from the door?
Oh yeah, I'm removing my hand from the door.
Okay. So after removing your hand, you take a moment to catch your breath, and your vision slowly returns to normal.
So what was that, Percy?
I
walked up to Percy.
Do I just start sweating?
I'm walking around the corner to him.
I guess sweating is autonomic, so yeah, sure. But you can, you know, react to this however you would.
Hey, Conti.
What?
Touch it.
You can see that he is visibly winded.
Dude, trust me, touch it.
I know no will not get us anywhere.
Nothing bad will happen. No. Don't worry. Just nothing bad will happen. Just touch it.
You look like hell.
It'll be fine. Just real quick. Just touch it real quick.
Honestly, I have the highest chance of being fine from this, from what I understand, with the fact that my language,
it doesn't hurt. It's just weird.
I cast Mage Hand. Open the door.
Describe how you are opening the door using Mage Hand.
Tongue is stuck out of my mouth as I concentrate.
No.
I keep getting distracted by Altum's cool tattoo that he won't stop talking about.
So a Mage Hand is basically just a remote control hand.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So to open a door with that Mage Hand, you would have to know how to manipulate the door.
Well, I mean, I'm going to attempt to open the door.
Okay. Describe how you're doing that.
Well, first I'm just going to slap it.
Okay. Nothing happens, I guess. Actually, wait. What did it go through? The Mage Hand link? I think specifically no. So
yeah, it can physically interact with things, so.
No. What I mean is, would the effect of touching the door...
Oh.
The hand through the can't attack, hand. Activate magic items, or carry more than 10 pounds.
Right. It kind of depends on how you interpret activate magic items, but yeah, I'm going to say that you slap the hand on the door and nothing happens.
I give up.
Doesn't even try pushing on it.
You tried one thing.
I'll try shoving on it like as hard as I can and stuff like that.
You're jumping in this water, really?
If you're trying to do like a strength
check,
like
up to his waist,
with a mage hand, what?
Mm-hmm.
I guess I'll let you do an intelligence check instead. I don't think that's how it's supposed to work, but let's try it.
You mean like a check or like a saving throw or?
Like a check. So you're basically trying to push the door up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do you realize that your mage hand can only do like 10 pounds?
Oh, that's right.
It can only carry 10 pounds?
That's actually Arcana.
So... You said do an intelligence-based check.
I said intelligence, not intelligence.
I mean, here we go.
Are you proficient in Arcana?
Yeah.
Sure you are.
So... Yeah, let me reroll. I'm happy, John?
I'll let you take the 12. So that should be 17. So you press the mage hand flat against the door and push upward, and with all of your mental strength, and the hand... What happens when the hand gets overexerted?
Poof.
I don't think it even does it.
I think it just disappears.
Something like those lines.
I don't know if it says anything happens.
I don't think it actually says anything happens.
In that case, nothing happens.
Great.
You can feel that the door, I'll give you this, you can feel that the door should slide up, but it feels like not only is the door extremely heavy, but you remember from before that there was some kind of magical lock holding it shut.
Magical lock, you say?
Yes.
Be a shame if someone had a spell.
Is that a spell?
that undid magical locks. I say out loud.
I don't think it's a spell. I think it's just, like, a password.
Conti, give me a wisdom check.
Okay.
I want to try to unstick you guys if I can.
I'm going to give him guidance.
This shouldn't be as hard as it is.
Can I put Conti's hand on the door?
Sure.
This isn't going to be contested because I'm, like, reacting to what Boaz said. So, like, he does it fast enough to where I don't react.
Which door?
The red one. The red door.
Dumb rogue you are.
The red door?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm...
As your hand touches the red door. Oh my god. So, let's resolve these in order. So, like, you're thinking about it, you're kind of, like, lost in thought, and then just pushes your hand against the door, and suddenly you hear the sounds of pitched battle all around you, and you feel exhausted from running and carrying your weapons through this fight, and you hear the roaring of beasts all around you, and your hand instinctively comes back off the stone, and you're still in this room. You're dripping with sweat.
Fucking weird,
you just
right?
Had the shit kicked out of you. You haven't taken any damage though. But at the same time, you
I've had a thought.
Realize you remember something. You remember that the figure made of mist from the entrance said that the Raven's Nest would open to you specifically.
Ah. Okay.
Did I help?
I without saying
because
anything,
you dealt the killing blow in the
fight
with the planetar.
Without saying a word, I'm gonna walk over to the Raven's door,
which Ultim is still standing staring at.
Yeah, and without saying a word to Ultim,
before you even touch the door,
okay,
just from standing close to it, it opens.
Fucking finally,
rip.
So as you get. It's like an automatic door, essentially. As you get within a few feet of it, you hear a click, and the door slides upward.
Mm-hmm.
And you also feel this sensation of being welcomed.
Mm. I'm going to continue on through.
Okay. Like... So,
Alton's right next to him.
Probably behind me, because you wouldn't...
Do you guys all go through? Before we go really through. Funny if Wait, some of you didn't, I guess.
Before we go through, Schmendrick?
Mm.
Conti, did you see the, or I guess hear, right? Not see.
Yes, I heard it.
Yeah. Should Schmendrick go check out the other door?
What, since he has that shield?
Yeah.
Maybe one thing at a time. Let's deal
Come
with
back to that.
Okay. Let's deal with the Raven's Nest before we go deal with like a cataclysmic shield. So
okay.
I'm gonna continue walking on in.
So climbing up onto the 5-foot ledge. Up to where the door actually is.
I don't know if I'd have to climb. I would just kind of like hop.
Oh, sure. Hopping up onto the 5-foot ledge where the door actually is. spraying some gross water as your feet fly up.
Right into Malton's face.
Nope. Malton's right next to you, man.
I don't think you can jump the same way I can.
You get up into this doorway, and you can see that there are like stone slots just underneath the doorway. Very small. And they have just opened when the door opened. And on the other side of the doorway, it again drops down 5 feet again. again. Why am I saying again so much?
Crazy barrier.
And up on either side, hang on, which room is this?
It's like they expected brackish water to be everywhere.
5 feet, well, some kind of fluid, right?
Yeah.
5 feet up on either side of you, there are these ledges that have rather less waterlogged and rather dustier furniture. As you pass through this place, you find there are piles of pillows and bookcases.
Yep.
And you see a large wooden framed globe. And it kind of looks like a study. Some very plush chairs.
Welcome to Gryffindor.
I'm going to check out the closest bookcase.
Okay.
I'm going to check out the furthest bookcase.
You haul yourself up onto one of the ledges and scamper over to the bookcase, and it's full of books. And going down...
They're probably really, really old, too.
You just want to start going down the spines? Is that what's happening here?
Basically, yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, John.
No problem, man. I'm prepared for this now.
Oh, all right, cool.
Because I know you. The first book is titled The High Spellbinder. And the second one is titled The Steward of the Dark.
I'm going to grab both these.
The next one is The Truth's Wait. Knife. There's hundreds.
Yeah, okay. These will be here.
Yes, they will.
After grabbing these two, it's like, hang on. We're taking this place. Okay, I can leave these books here.
Paladin in the Well.
Is there any in particular, like, from my knowledge of books and history, that's like, maybe I should grab these now?
Give me an investigation check.
Okay.
To try to find something real quick.
Yep.
Really?
I was gonna say that, like, I'm looking around the room for other...
Yeah. Because I'm just, like, because I know enough about books and what has been written in history that there's some that just probably shouldn't be read.
What do you mean?
Owning's fine. Like, cataclysmic type spells and shit like that.
That sounds like fun.
Right?
Fun
and cataclysmic. Okay.
Who else was searching?
I was.
Excuse me.
Anyone who wants to search, go ahead and make an investigation check.
I'm searching for everything, not just books.
Okay.
Yeah, my interest just got pulled instantly for that. So whatever else anybody else wants to do.
Do you want me to do investigation to try and search for whatever the fuck was giving me that unholy feeling?
You don't need to do a search for that. You can feel it radiating off that door.
So it's just the door?
Yeah, it's like being next to a source of intense heat, right? And that you can just feel the heat radiating off of it. But it's not heat, it's like sickness. Wrongness.
Did I get anything like that when I went near or passed through?
So it's like an upside down cross.
Kind of, yeah.
Okay. I'm probably just standing there staring at you, though.
Nobody else is paying any attention to this.
Yeah, I'm probably just standing there staring at the fucking door.
let me resolve these other things. Boaz, so you immediately notice a chest of drawers that you start rummaging through. And, well, actually, I guess I shouldn't. Do you want to check for traps?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
How do I do that? Sleight of hand?
I think that's also investigation.
Yeah, it's an investigation check.
Yeah.
I have a plus eight.
There's no
Wow.
No way.
That's surprising.
Sherlock gnomes, you know?
Yeah. No way. So do you open it?
Yeah.
Okay. Poof. You open up the doors and inside you see some fancy clothes. It's too big for you, unfortunately.
Damn it.
You see a book titled The Riddle Master's Haven.
Yeah, slip Ooh. That in the bag.
Sounds so Sorry, interesting. Man. Sounds so interesting.
The Riddle Master's
Haven. You find a few coins. Very okay. old coins. There are 18 silver pieces here. Very old coins.
Do I have to separate that they're very old, or do I just add 18 silver?
Up to you. You can make a note of it if you want, but they, you know that these coins, you see them every once in a while. Seeing like more than one at a time is pretty odd. They're not worth any more, right?
Okay.
Maybe to some weird collector, but good luck finding that in a world that's been torn apart.
Vilnik.
But yeah, it just strikes me that it's odd that these coins are so old. At the time, they would have been much more valuable than they are now.
Okay. I'll take them.
Okay.
John, after my fuck up of the roll right there, I probably realized, like, yeah, probably not going about this the right way. Are any book titles in Irian? Or can I check for that?
Ah. I would say with that, investigation roll, you don't notice any.
Okay.
You could always try again later.
Did I run across anything weird?
At the moment.
With my shitty 12?
With a 12, you don't really notice anything that hasn't already been pointed out. Digging around through some of the furniture, you find a broken mirror and some more clothing. You also notice that there's a weapon rack covered in well-made but ordinary mundane weapons. You notice daggers feature prominently. I guess I'll also give you that at the far end of the room, as you're kind of traversing through this long, relatively narrow room, at the far end, you find an assortment of locks.
Huh?
Like locks, like baskets full of locks.
They're not attached to anything, they're just a box of locks.
Yeah, it's like a box of padlocks and like door locks that have been detached and are never installed or whatever. Just like, it's like, just hundreds and hundreds of locks. All different styles.
Are they locked or unlocked?
This room has two of my obsessions in it. Wonderful.
Well, time to say goodbye to that character. He's gonna be here for the rest of his life.
Right. You notice that the locks aren't locked onto anything. They're just sitting in these baskets.
I don't know what I mean. You know,
they actually seem to have been organized by type.
Yeah,
like there's a basket of padlocks.
Yeah, you could have a padlock closed and sitting on a table.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, are they locked? Is what I'm asking.
Wait a minute.
Yes, as far as you can tell, they're all locked.
Okay.
Who found these locks?
Us?
You guys are seeing them.
Yeah, we all see
them. There's an enormous collection.
Yeah.
And actually, next to it, there is a display
case. I was going to ask you to do that.
So, just to the side, there is a display case that features some really complicated, ornate locks.
I want to see if any of these locks are magic.
Okay. With that arcana check, some of them are.
Take the magic, boys.
Specifically the ones in the display case. So one is an ornate door lock, it looks like. It's got like a knob on either side of it. And looks like it's, you know, supposed to be installed in a door.
Okay.
There are two gold padlocks with very intricate designs around them. One of which has 7 keyholes.
Jesus. So there's 3 locks total?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, John, did you say
all
that
of them are emanating this aura of abjuration magic?
Ooh.
Are there keys?
There are no keys. Anywhere.
That's interesting. You said is there a desk in this room?
Yeah, there are a couple of little writing desks.
All right. Is there anyone that's like more prominent than the other? Like that's the main desk in this room?
No. In fact, they all seem to be identical.
Okay.
And since you're looking at them specifically, I'll point out that there's 9 of them.
Okay.
And in fact, there seem to be kind of like 9 areas. Like 9 distinct, I guess you might charitably call them study areas or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Where there's a chair and a desk and some... I don't know how to describe this.
It's like an old school library study.
You find what looks like I really don't know how to describe this in a way that'll be useful. Basically, each of these areas look like they were previously divided with like fold out divider screens.
Mm-hmm.
But the screen material has actually rotted away over the years. So there's just these pieces of wood that are jointed together lying on the floor.
So it's almost like a weird
reverse engineer what these must have been.
So it's almost like a weird testing center type thing.
Kind of, yeah. It's got kind of a
they minus sure the separators to. Now.
I don't know where that went. Did that go into random?
Not quite like that, no. But
yeah.
It's a little more lavish than that.
A little bit. Generally.
Yeah. I have an idea what you're talking about. Okay.
You also find another upside down wall lever thing.
Oh, I'm going to flip that.
More windows open.
Cool.
What's for like light switches?
No staircase happened into the floor this time. Just the no. Okay. This is weird because same view as before.
Yeah. So the windows are full of stained glass, so they're a little difficult to look through. But peeking through some of the more transparent areas and focusing, you see a rolling pastoral scene beyond.
It's a screensaver.
You see a herd of horses running across the hills.
Animated screensaver.
And then looking through a window on the other side of the room, you see the same herd of horses running.
Oh, that's all kinds of weird.
And actually, all of these windows look very similar.
Like, they could be showing the exact same image.
They seem to all be the same window. in a very literal sense.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Somebody went nuts with the copy-paste.
In this room, is there
So you also find... Sorry, so this room is like basically a long hallway that's got some of these study areas. As you go down, every... let's say 20 feet or so, you find a door. This is just a regular door. A wooden door banded with iron with a pull ring. Very similar to the ones that you saw in the building above. The ones that don't have to have any special security on them. But they do have locks. Just regular locks. As far as you can tell. That is... Oh, and then at the other, at the far end of the room, next to where all the locks are, there is another stone door above this kind of trough that runs down the middle of the room. That I imagine at some point somebody has dropped a board down, like one of you has dropped like a board down across it so you can go back and forth. It's a very strange way to design a room.
Yeah.
Or you also noticed like tattered bits of carpet at the bottom of the trough.
Do you guys want to check out the stone door at the end of the hallway, or do you guys want to check out the wooden doors?
Tomato, tomato.
I'm curious to see if there's like an office or something at the end of this hallway, or yeah. what's at the end. We can check out the other two doors here on our way back if we come back this way or whatever. But let's check out that stone door. So I'm going to go over to that door.
Okay.
I'm going to resist going after the locks for now.
As you approach the door at the far end, that's at this kind of awkward angle because the door is basically at the end of the trough, like lined up with it. So you have to kind of step at this weird angle to get over to it from the area that's not depressed 5 feet to the ground. It's really inconvenient. Whoever designed this place is really bad at designing buildings. That was not meta. I was not insulting myself. but as you near this door, it opens.
Cool.
And you see beyond, again, the floor drops down 5 feet.
Okay.
And across the way, you see about 20 feet away, you see a T-junction. And then about 20 feet from there, you see another stone door. But the one on the far end bears the symbol of the red symbol, right?
Okay.
Is there water on the ground?
At the T-junction, it looks wet, but there's not, like, water pooled there. But it looks like it was recently wet. And you can actually see what looks like natural light spilling in into the T-junction.
Ah, okay.
But whatever the source is, it's around the corner to the right.
To the right? Okay.
Yeah, so you continue down to the junction and then turn right, and that's where the light seems to be coming from. If you go that way.
Okay.
I'm going to go take a quick peek at that light.
Yeah, I'm going to walk
so you
down there.
Hop down, steady yourself on the somewhat slippery floor. You see, again, at this 5 foot level, there's this kind of moss or algae green streaks on the walls. And as you come to the corner, you see you are in the main hall. At the far end, you see the doors still braced open with that large timber.
Well, at least we know how to get out of here.
Yeah.
You see McGillicuddy beyond. There are people working feverishly on the ditch outside, or the moat.
Mm-hmm.
What time of day is it?
It is late afternoon.
How late in the afternoon?
The sun is still firmly up.
Did it look the same outside the windows in the throne room?
No, it did not. It looked like it was a different time of day. It looked probably more like noon proper. Like as the day grows late, the colors starts to kind of warm, right?
Uh-huh.
That wasn't happening. It still looked like middle of the day lighting, as opposed to like the slowly, you know, darkening, warming colors of late afternoon. in addition, outside it's actually kind of overcast. When you looked through the windows, it was bright, clear sky, bright blue sky. You know for a fact that there are no horses out there, because that's been a problem. And it seems to be a different place. A different season.
Nice.
Who knows? Maybe a different universe. At this point. Hard to rule anything out.
I'm going to, now that we are back at the main area, I'm going to go back and check those doors.
Okay. They are locked.
Okay. Boaz, are these locks magical? Or do I need to worry about that? I don't feel like getting electrocuted right now.
I'll carry over your 27 Arcana before.
Just say I'm a magic lock expert.
These locks, well, just because it's close in time and related, these locks don't appear to be magical in any way.
Okay, I'm going to try and open it.
Okay. Thieves tools.
Yep. Coming up. I'm going to fuck this up. Nope. 18.
Okay. The locks are well made, but you are good at what you do. And after a few minutes of digging around in there, you hear ping, and the lock clicks open, and you're able to turn the cylinder and open the door.
All right.
Assuming
I'm going to slowly open the door, keeping an eye out for traps.
Okay. Give me an investigation check. I guess I'm never quite sure whether where the line between investigation and perception is. Those two are a little fuzzy. Not quite as fuzzy as athletics and acrobatics, but
yeah.
Still. Anyway.
Yeah, I'm not sure how to handle for traps, but yeah.
Let's do investigation.
Okay.
I basically at this point I'm just going off of
17.
Mercer does this, so
yeah.
I'm just gonna copy him.
Yeah, I was honestly thinking of what they I remember for last time for the traps,
it's like perception at a distance, investigation up close seems to be the rule of thumb, which makes sense.
Yeah.
So feeling around the edge of the doorway, you don't notice any catch mechanisms or anything like that. Everything seems legit.
Hunky-dory. Mm-hmm. All right. So yeah, I'm going to open the door and walk in.
100 poison darts do not hit you. The door swings open. It's technically true.
Yeah.
Just not relevant. Door swings open. It's a bedroom. There's a bed with a chest at the bottom. There's actually two sets of bunks. So a total of four beds with, what are those called? Footlockers at the bottom. Mm-hmm. Annoying people in black and white striped outfits try to sell you shoes. No. So there's chests at the foot of the beds.
Okay.
Two bunks, two chests at the end of each bed. There's a small desk in the center between the two beds.
I'll have a look in the desk.
Okay.
I'm looking for written stuff, names, as they do.
So on the desk you find a note. Do you want to write this down?
Yes. Let me
okay.
Attempt to be ready to write it down. Hang on. I'm actually going to write it down rather than type.
I mean, I guess I could give it over to you, but.
If you could, that would be way much better. Because the pen I have sucks and my typing sucks.
Okay.
Ow.
Is someone chain smoking or am I hallucinating what? The sound?
Oh, that?
Yeah.
That's my pen.
Sounds like a Zippo to me.
Hear that or you're hearing that? Nope, that's not picking up.
So it has that 5-digit number on it.
Okay.
That's 6 digits.
6-digit number.
Okay.
571283.
8675309.
It's a little scrap of paper, kind of like a fortune cookie thing. But it's just a little long strip of paper that has this number written on it. In addition to this, you find a lot of locks. So there are locks piled up on the desk. Opening the drawer, locks. Opening the other drawer, lock picks.
Jesus.
I'm going to replenish any that I need. wait, we're not playing Wild Ends.
But yeah, so you find thieves' tools, essentially.
Yeah.
If anybody wants a set of thieves' tools.
Right.
And a,
like a Percy? Bunch
of padlocks. Basically. Maybe later.
Yeah. Okay. Is there a... you said that was what was in the drawers, essentially?
Yes. And okay. You also... find a book.
Ooh!
Its title is Blade in the Earth.
Okay.
And it is dog-eared like crazy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna pocket that for now.
Okay. You also find three daggers. Again, well-made steel, but nothing out of the ordinary as far as you can tell.
Yeah, no runes or nothing on them. Yeah,
they don't say that seem, they're... I mean, maybe they're super low-key, but they don't seem magic.
Okay.
Magic.
However,
one of them is all black.
It looks
as if it's been treated with something to turn it black.
Okay, I'm trying to think if I have anything to put that in. I don't think I have anything. I haven't just really grabbed. Here. Yeah. Yeah, but in case it's like the blackening.
Mysterious weapon. Throw it into my bag.
Right.
Stick it in your boot.
I'm just gonna take one of the extra pieces of traveler's clothes I have in my bag and wrap the dagger in it. And then put it away. That way, just
sure.
In case it's poison or some shit like that, for whatever reason, that black coating's on it.
So go ahead and add a black steel dagger to your
equipment. Okay.
Is anybody else doing anything in this space?
I will pet my boar.
Is that a euphemism?
It squeals with delight.
With delight.
Have you been carrying your boar up and down all these like 5 foot things?
I hope so.
He's just been throwing the diving belt over and letting it sail through the air.
It's squeezed up into the helmet with the octopus.
All right. Well, I'm gonna just go across.
Coming out of the like vents.
I'm gonna go across. That'd be so fucking rude.
It's wearing the octopus as a
hat. Door, right? It's like the door on the front of the helmet is open and the snout is just...
Oh my god.
That makes no sense.
It's like some weird Studio Ghibli character.
Oh god.
I'm gonna go to the other side and open that, unlock that door if it's locked and open it.
Can the boar fly a plane?
Give me thieves tools again.
Okay. Really, anyway, I got that reference, you know, I have that movie.
no problem. So, you know what? Actually, with that awesome thieves tool roll,
the door comes off the hinges.
As you're going through the door, or as you're going through the lock, and you're feeling it out and opening it up, you're just mentally mapping out the cylinder. You notice it has 6 pins. And the first one is about halfway up. The second one is very deep. The third one is super shallow. The next one, pretty shallow. The next one, whoa, that's like 3 false sets before you finally get it in there. Really. And then the last one's kind of in the middle again, and then it pops open. You're thinking, huh. That seems familiar.
He's thinking, huh.
Did you make the connection?
I did. Out of character.
Not really, actually.
Let me put it this way. You think the bidding for that lock might be 571283.
Oh, okay.
So you pop the lock open, and it's another dormitory.
Okay.
And in fact, well, that's what this place is starting to feel like.
In the dormitory? Okay. Mm-hmm.
Welcome to Slytherin.
For fuck's sake. I am going to check the desk again.
Oh, although, okay, so yeah, checking the desk here, you find some clothing, some like women's clothing in dark colors.
Uh-oh.
And you find an envelope that is sealed with a wax seal. You also find locks, daggers, thieves' tools, the whole kit.
Welcome to Bellatrix's room.
Oh god.
You find a bottle of perfume.
Okay.
it's true.
Do I recognize the seal on the letter?
Could you possibly?
Maybe I should take a look too.
Yeah, to you at least, it's not familiar.
Okay, I can't make like a history check or something like that for it.
I mean, you wouldn't really have any.
No chance. Okay.
No.
Okay. I'll let Schmendrick take a look at it, but I am going to keep it in my hands.
Okay. So you go ahead and roll a. I would it be history? I guess so. Sure, history. Actually, yes, this would totally be history.
I will guide myself.
Concentration. Ooh, nice.
So you don't recognize the seal immediately, but thinking on it a little bit, you remember. So there was this noble house that was at one time, this is going a ways back for you at this point, but at one time was an ally of yours. And they were called House Tenare. And their symbol was changed at some point. When they needed to distance themselves from some shady dealings with Talon Rest.
Didn't we meet this bitch?
This is their old sigil.
Yeah, this is before...
Or their old coat of arms.
Basically. This is before it was changed to an owl. Right? It was an owl? Yeah.
I believe you're thinking of... Tenore.
Tenore, okay. I have it written out as Tenori.
Which admittedly is a very similar word.
Yeah. That's instantly what I'd check my notes.
Related, you could say. I certainly wouldn't know. I'm just an old man.
God damn it.
What are you doing in my house?
The darkness.
Anyway.
I'm going to look at it and be like, and ask Schmender, he's like, should we open it? I mean, who knows how long this place has actually been shut up.
I don't see why not.
All right. Yeah, I'm going to open it and take a look.
Sealed with red wax. Okay. You're opening it?
Yes.
Okay.
Roll initiative.
So you break the seal open, and... It is, what's the right term for this?
Box.
So there's a love letter, right?
Yeah.
And then there's like a,
it's a Dear really John letter?
Polite rejection letter.
Ooh.
But it's Ouch. Not, you know, it's not a... of the like, you know, like let's just be friends variety. Yeah. It's of the you know it's forbidden variety.
Oh,
it's a Padme letter. Got it.
And part of it, indicates that the I don't have this name. basically, one of the guys across the hall might be onto us. And
what?
She caught him snooping.
Kinky.
Maybe I should change the lock.
Ah, okay. So, a little bit of a mystery there, but that's cool.
Hey,
so,
Conti.
What?
You done sniffing panties? Can we get a move on here? What's going on?
I'll point out also that for you, because I forgot that it was you who was reading this, there's an undercurrent here in Thieves Camp.
Yeah.
It's very subtle. Like, subtle enough that you almost don't notice it.
Well, it seems like they might have been.
That it's like the official content of the letter is like, oh, if only, but we can't. But then, like, the actual subtext is like, you know, meet me on the fifth floor tomorrow at midnight, right? Like,
yeah.
So, anyway, that's the kind of thing you're seeing right now.
Okay. That makes sense. That'd be kind of tough to read, anyways, because it seems like this whole area is designed to teach people subterfuge. So,
yes. That's an accurate read.
Yeah. Which also means, like, it's funny at the same time because it's like, if everybody around you is learning the same thing, why would you bother using it? But either way, like, yeah, that's cool. Okay.
So those are the two of the doors on the end. There's a total of 20 doors in all.
Oh, jeez.
I'm assuming you're not going to go through all of them.
I didn't realize there was that many. I thought there was just these two.
Nope, there's 10 on each side.
Maybe some other time.
To the red door?
Do any of them look like they're more important than the rest? Like a doormaster's door?
Yeah. So there is a, like, roughly halfway down, there is a set of double doors. So I guess there's actually 22 doors, counting the double doors.
Yeah.
But on one side, there's a set of double doors. No, right, that's why. Because there's a set of double doors on one side instead of two individual doors.
Okay.
That's why. Like, I know I counted this right. And they're physically taller and wider. But the construction is similar.
Okay, yeah, no, I would definitely like to check that out.
Okay. These ones pull open without effort and open into a dark space beyond.
Okay. Is it just a dark space? There's what's there?
Up above, you see stars.
Okay.
Do you step into this room?
Yeah.
It's just kind of darkness. It really only resolves itself as you step through the threshold.
Mm-hmm.
But as you step through the threshold, you come out onto the roof of a building. And there's a cold wind. And or rather like a cold breeze. There is almost
brisk.
Still, but not quite, right? Mm-hmm. And it's dark. It must be in the middle of the night. You see stars up ahead, up above. The moon, the crescent moon, and there are rooftops, and you see figures in the distance darting from rooftop to rooftop.
Ninjas.
Wait, figures?
Mm-hmm. Like humanoid figures, darting silently through the night.
Okay.
Across the rooftops.
That's what you see. Yeah.
And then, like, kind of what, you know, looking back, you see these double doors just opening out onto a rooftop. Off of, like, the side of the building, up, like, the next story up, basically.
Does it seem like they might have seen me, or, like, the reason they were darting was because they were running away, or...
They are moving perpendicular to, like, the direction you're facing.
Okay.
So they don't seem to be reacting to your presence. They just seem to be moving through this space.
This is weird.
Very weird.
That said, if you're worried about being seen, there is a skill for that.
I'm actually, in this case, like, I would more want to be seen, because I'm gathering information rather than trying to kill someone.
I think maybe we should come back to this.
Sure. Do you want to try to flag them down or get their attention?
Yeah. This is really interesting, because this, I just...
To get their attention.
You want me to get their attention for you?
Where are you guys, actually?
I've been following him. I've been following him the whole time.
So really?
If you follow him out into the threshold, so you'd see him step into, like, the shadows, and you can't see him anymore. So as you step out into this dark space as well, you are also standing on a rooftop.
I'm going to just, like, wave and be like, hey!
Cool. Roll initiative.
Smooth.
Really? I thought they might be students or whatever, so I didn't check.
You know what? Let's not go into initiative just yet.
Okay.
So
where's the door compared to us?
Behind us. I think, right? That's where it was.
Which door?
The double doors we walk through. You said, like, if we
they're right behind you. Like, you're just standing just outside them.
Okay.
I'd probably say stand near them, near enough to make sure they don't shut.
Give me a dex save.
Oh, okay.
Both of us?
Me or both of us?
I guess both of you.
Okay.
Since you're both there. Okay.
Probably both rolled crap.
Conti's got a 12. Percy has 11. Okay. You hear and three darts fly out of the shadows and strike each of you. You feel a burning sensation as they dig into your skin. You see this dark copper-colored ichor dripping off the barbs. Give me con saves.
Oh, great. Rip, now I'm dead.
Rip. Yep.
Now I'm fucked. I'm gonna get knocked out first. No, I did better than you. What? How the fuck?
And no, we're off by one again.
Yeah.
Okay.
Funny. No, we rolled the same that time.
So you each take 8 points of piercing damage.
Ow. That hurt.
Wow.
Okay.
Wait, darts are 2d10?
These are not normal darts.
They're like chainsaw darts.
He said make a con save, I assume they're poison darts.
Okay. Yeah, you know, I guess I should do this properly.
I wasn't going to contest it.
Okay, so you each takes 17 points of piercing damage.
Wait, why 17?
Because you each get hit with 3 darts. And it's plus
8. Oh shit, the 8 was the first one?
No.
So you get hit with 3 d4 darts each. 6 okay. darts in total. Right? So 17 okay. points of damage each. But you are unaffected by the poison.
Okay.
As it begins to seep into your bloodstream, you shrug it off. And you hear... the figures that you previously saw disappear into the shadows. What are you guys going to do? I'll give you just a moment to decide.
Run.
I'm going to pet my boar.
Just completely... So inside, you guys are completely oblivious.
Yeah, these...
It's like, where'd they go? What are they doing?
God,
I like just cutting between these two scenes, you know, outside, like,
I'm going back to the fucking door.
Or whatever, you know, inside, just like somebody's playing a violin in the background, not really, but that would be the leitmotif.
Okay, whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna go back inside.
Okay.
That sucked. So you guys
come
bad.
Back in bleeding, just like peppered
yeah,
with needles.
Like doors shut behind us on each side. Like, ow!
As you're shutting the doors, six more darts stick into the door and you just
Jesus.
Slam it shut.
That's not how you open doors.
That's not how you start a conversation either. Fuck.
Yeah, that was not fun.
now.
Okay. Also, you guys immediately regain those hit points.
Wait, what?
Oh!
Looking at your arms, you see there's nothing that's stuck into you.
That's fucking...
Oh, you can still feel the pain, but they're gone.
It yeah, like so we noticed that pretty quick. We're like, oh, fuck, it's a training room. Ow.
Still sucked. Still sucked. Now should we go check out the red room door?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. As you guys close the doors, you notice a dial above one of the doorknobs that has a symbol of a crescent moon in a little window, and then there's a dial beneath it.
Okay.
So just like throwing that out there.
So like denoting how dark it is.
Mm-hmm. I turn the dial.
I was about to say that, but yeah.
Okay. You turn the dial, the next symbol is like three chains interlinked.
Okay.
Like the symbol for a link, you know, like the icon for a link.
Yeah.
On Wikipedia or whatever.
Let's turn it again.
Word. Okay. You turn it again and it is two crossed swords.
Sparring room. Okay. And again.
Crescent moon.
Okay, so three settings. Wonderful.
What was the middle one?
Weakest link. It's a link.
You turn it again, and it's because you don't quite remember. It's three interlinked chain links.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We'll come back to this.
Yeah.
That hurt.
Aww. Okay.
I need a drink That's after fine. Getting my ass whooped.
You guys don't have to stay forever.
Let's go check out the red door, which actually we probably should go back red to the main door? Room. Red door. Red door.
If we go back the way we came.
The Cardinal's door.
Oh,
but
sure.
You
could do that.
We should probably Cardinals. Go back to the. Right.
It sounds like the. Never mind.
Yeah.
Trying to find the Pope, damn it.
Oh, that's not what I was thinking.
I
baseball team.
That's what I was thinking of.
What the hell?
Baseball.
I think it's baseball. Yeah.
It's baseball.
And I wasn't sure. I just went off.
It was baseball.
But my instinct was right, apparently. So.
I'm trying to remember back in the main hall. Did we do anything with the red statue yet?
No.
Which one was the red one? The middle one.
Yeah, the one that was left, other than the white statue, which is holding a bowl.
Are you saying that in character?
If you need me to.
Because if you mention the bowl, I'm going to mention the bowl.
That bowl?
Yeah, that bowl.
Why? I had just thought about that when you said that, but, like... All right, whatever.
I was like, yeah, I found a weird-ass bowl back there. And it seemed very weird, so I just let it be until we figured out a way out of here first.
Yeah, you left it back there decent ways.
Yeah.
It's literally on the top floor.
It is.
it's literally up like three flights of stairs. It's not that far.
It's actually 10 flights of stairs.
Yeah. Let's go deal with this. Let's see if there's anything we need to deal with at that red statue. And then the rest of us can take a short rest while you run back up there and get it.
Okay.
I think that says well.
Okay, so what do you guys
You could actually, you could probably dimension door up there, couldn't you?
No.
No, not that far? Okay.
No, the more I've seen this place, the more I'm afraid to dimension door anywhere besides the same room.
True.
I'm going to dimension door out of existence if I try to change the rooms.
Yeah, true. Okay, but yeah,
I mean, you guys could try it. What's the worst that could happen?
Poof.
He just said.
One of two things will happen.
No, he one of two things begin to imagine the worst that could happen.
One of two things can happen. I can dimension door wherever the hell I want, because whatever, or I just won't exist anymore, and I don't want to take that chance.
And those are the two best options. There's worse. Anyways, yeah. Do you guys want to check out that middle statue, or the red statue, the one that's left? See if we can figure out that puzzle.
Yeah, we could.
Yep.
So, okay. Yeah, whatever.
Well, it kind of seems like we're missing something here.
What, in the Ravens area?
Like, with the dial and all that.
That's a training room.
Yeah.
With different settings.
Do you want to check the other two settings?
No.
No?
No.
God damn
it. Okay, I'll check.
I was about to say, it's like...
I'm not there.
No, I want to check.
That's not how that works.
Fuck Percy. Okay.
Which setting is it now?
Let's go to the chain link one. Does that sound good for you, Boaz?
Yeah.
Yeah, right, let's open that up. Okay. Take a peek.
I'm not peeking. Fuck that shit. I'll stand by the doors. I ain't going through.
The door opens into a space with a gray ambient light that seems to... It's like a fog. Do you guys step inside?
Nope. Yeah, I'll step inside.
Sure. Okay. What's the worst gonna happen?
As you step inside... Oh.
So three of us walk in this time. Me, Boaz, and Schmender.
As you step inside, you each find yourself in a different prison cell.
Oh, God.
Oh. All right.
You have none of your possessions on you.
Okay.
You are wearing just rough spun clothing. There is a smelly pile of straw on the floor, and you have a single lockpick in your possession.
Rip. Not me, but the rest of you guys, rip.
Turning back behind you, you see the door is gone.
Yep.
You can, however, see the door in front of you on the other side of the locked bars.
Okay.
A guard walks past, patrolling.
Oh, shit.
I would like to say, out of character, this room is exactly what I thought it was going to be.
I had no idea.
As the guard walks by, he turns and looks at you, Boaz. Give me a... well, what are you going to do?
I'm going to cast Minor Illusion.
Okay.
I'm going to illuse...
That's the verb?
A guard behind him.
Okay.
Yelling for his attention. Like in a berating fashion. Can I do that with Minor Illusion?
Can Minor Illusion make sound?
Yes.
Right, that's the difference between silent image, right?
Sure.
Okay, sure. So he turns and instinctively snaps to attention. Okay.
Then I'm going to cast Message. And tell Conti, pick the fucking lock.
I'm not in the same cell as you.
But I can see him, right? Can I see Conti?
No, it's an image or a sound.
I didn't do an image.
I thought you said you were making a guard who was screaming.
Oh, was it just the sound of a guard?
The sound of a guard screaming.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. After snapping to attention, he turns and looks around and can't seem to identify where the sound is coming from.
It was just supposed to be long enough to talk to Conti, but I guess I can't.
No, that's fine. So you can talk to Conti.
Wait, where am I in comparison to where he's at?
You're across the cell block.
Oh, I see. I thought you were in like three separate cell blocks. Okay.
You're in three separate cells.
Yeah.
Of the same block.
Okay. You know what? I mean, I could just...
Okay. Where are you aiming that sucker?
Right at his face.
The guard?
Yeah.
Oh, this is going to end well.
What's he going to do?
You cast Firebolt. You hit the guard with the Firebolt, and he drops his polearm and screams as fire starts to burn his face, and then your vision fades to white, Boaz.
Fail.
And you find yourself standing in the hallway again.
I did it, guys!
You are holding an iron medallion in your hands.
Yeah. I just watch you like I'm just standing there like by the door, like I can't believe you guys just do that, and now you just reappear, like you materialize next to me with an iron medallion. I'll get like,
so while happened? This is happen, so while that happened, so that happened down the hall for me is Boaz lit the guard's face on fire, right?
Yes.
Okay, this would be an opportunity.
So
okay.
You see that happen. And then there's a flash of light, and the guard walks past an empty cell.
Oh, like, so he's fine now?
Yeah. It's like he's been reset.
Okay.
Wall.
Hi.
The medallion has three raised, outlined star shapes on it. Like, embossed.
Hmm.
By the way.
Oh, cool. I'm wearing it.
Okay. It has a word on it in a script you can't read.
The hell is that?
It's my participation award, man.
What the hell was in there?
Conti was dropping soap on the ground. Things happen.
So I get that Conti's in there. Who else was in there?
Schmendrick.
Schmendrick's in there, too? Okay. So you guys are both in your own prison cells.
Yep.
I'm thinking about it.
Okay. You actually can't see each other. Boaz, you could see that they were right next to each other from the other side of the hall.
Okay.
Neither of them know this.
Oh, so he's going to love what I'm about to do. This might be a dumb idea. No.
Probably.
No, actually, I can't do that. Damn it. I'm out
another
of spells.
Another guard comes by. Ching, 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 ching. His sword wrapping each of the bars in turn.
Erica.
How closely was he walking by?
Well, his sword, which is, like, in its scabbard, was smacking against the bars as he was walking, so he was right next to the bars.
He didn't happen to have keys on his belt, did he?
He did indeed.
Okay. Has he already walked all the way by?
No, you can go ahead and take this moment to act on this.
Okay. Sleight of hand!
So the key ring.
Oh, I saw that 22.
Almost comically oversized key ring.
Yeah. 18?
Yeah. Yeah, no problem. You slip through the bars and take the key ring off of this person. You hear the sound of a small bell in the distance.
While he's doing that, I'm gonna polymorph into cat.
Nice!
I'm going to unlock my cell.
Okay. Meanwhile, Schmendrick becomes a cat.
I was gonna just out of character, my plan was to actually hand the keys to Schmendrick first.
Nice.
So I didn't know that.
Yeah, no, that's I like your style way more.
So
that's awesome.
You reach out the bars and slot the key in and turn it and open the door and turn to your left and you see a cat looking up at you. The guard is now receding away from you. He goes, and starts to turn around.
Make a run for it.
I'm going to freeze time really briefly.
Yeah.
So,
go ahead.
Behind me. So you see that there's like a railing and then there's a drop. You're on the third floor apparently of this block, and down below you is a floor which would be like the most, like the lowest level of the dungeon or whatever, right? And then up above there is one more floor, and then you can see the door that you came in up at the top.
So okay,
you need to go up one floor to get to the exit, apparently.
Okay.
And there is a guard that is just about to start descending the staircase from above. And there's also the one that's turning around right in front of you. What do you guys do?
Okay, I'm going... So this is just above us.
Yes. But there's also the guard right in front of you who is turning around and having heard a cat meow.
Yep. Right, so I'm looking down the hall towards him and to, like, my left or right is a railing, and then on the other side of the railing's a drop down, and then a
yeah,
one
so
floor
there's
above.
Yeah, so there's a drop downward, okay. But the exit is above you. Cause
okay.
A, you know.
And I can see that area. It's like an open...
Subterranean prison.
It's like Alcatraz-type prison cell to where I can see the prisons up above.
Yeah, yeah.
At, it's
like
open.
An open air shaft.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
you would also know that this is underground. So down is not the exit.
Right. I won't be able to do it with Shrendrick. I'm going to hop the rail and jump up to the next area.
Oh, okay. This is like some
acrobatic
shit.
Persia
shit is what
yeah.
this is.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's actually athletics because it's a jump thing.
Okay, this is one I'm going to contest, because why wouldn't it be acrobatics?
He's trying to parkour it.
So acrobatics is about, like, trying to roll without hurting yourself and things like that.
I'm trying to basically parkour up there.
Right, which means you're trying to clear 10 feet vertically, which is a strength thing. Not a...
it's a fucking big gap to go up vertically with nothing.
Yeah,
to,
you have to
with...
jump up a story, essentially.
You don't have anything to... You don't have anything to, like, Mario triple jump
I guess I could give you acrobatics, because, sure.
Because to me, this definitely seems more like acrobatics than athletics.
Like I said, this is one of those areas where the distinction kind of breaks down.
Yeah.
I actually wish they would just...
DAE.
Sorry. Combine those two.
Just remember, you have to say hardcore parkour.
Oh, and of course I will. Fucking one. I'm going to fall.
So rip. you leap over the railing and strike your head on the floor above you, which is closer than you expected, and tumble forward and fall three stories.
Dead.
You must now roleplay Conti as having severe brain damage.
You...
It's going to be my shiver.
Brain bramage.
So you take 7 points of bludgeoning damage as you crack your head on the floor.
Yeah,
it's 1d6 for every 10 feet after the first 10 feet, I think.
It's not bad.
So, or something like that. I don't know. Whatever.
That'll sounds legit. Up
properly one of these days. But the point is, you take some bludgeoning damage when you hit
that.
That's
legit.
Mostly,
yes.
Mostly you hurt yourself and make a loud sound, and you see a flash of white. And you are standing back inside the hall, and you have a bronze medal in your hands. Shpendrick, you're still a cat. The guard turns and looks and leans down over the railing, shrugs, and says, "Must have been the wind." And then turns around and
God
walks
damn it.
From you.
It's a hell of a wind.
At this very moment, Gary disappears.
Gary?
Gary.
It's Gary.
His
the
unseen servant.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. No, I thought that was the flame thing. He.
My Azur.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
God, you guys don't.
So, Cat Shpendrick, what you up to?
I'm going to stealthily make my way towards the other guard, who I'm assuming he's coming from the door direction, right?
Yeah, he's descending from.
Well, legally up to the curb.
What's happening?
Percy, mute yourself for now.
Well, yeah, but it needs to be like within so many inches of the curb.
18 inches is the same as California. Yeah. Anyway.
12 here.
Okay.
I'm assuming you want me to do a stealth for this.
So give me a stealth as you try to ascend the stairs, skipping past the notice of the guard.
So I have the stats of the cat. The cat has +4 stealth, so...
I believe that's right.
I can't believe I failed at acrobatics. I have a +10 on it. For fuck's sake.
Nice. So you slip You slip right past the cat. Or the cat. The guard without him noticing. Just right between the legs. And
yeah, I figured I would like solid snake my way around and get up to the door.
Nice. So you are now up to the door.
There are no cardboard boxes.
The door is closed.
You are your cat.
Is what kind of
you
like?
You see a guard that is just starting their rotation up on this level.
What kind of like handle or something does the door have?
It is an iron pull ring that is at about, it would be waist level if you were you. So it's like, I don't know, what, 3-4 feet up, something like that.
That's not too bad for a cat. I'll jump and grab it.
It's like nothing for a cat.
Okay. Make a strength check to try to open the door.
Oh, as a cat, that's not going to work out.
Yeah, you don't even have to roll to get up there, but you might have to roll to actually pull it open. Yeah, you just don't really have anything to push yourself against, so you're just basically holding onto it and flailing.
Okay, well, I'm...
Which looks hilarious, but it's also silent.
I guess I'll remove my cat form and become a normal person again.
Okay.
So, as a normal person, am I Shemendrick, or is this like a temporary... prisoner body or something?
No, so you slip back into your normal human form. I'm assuming you quickly dart out the door?
Yes, if the door will let me through.
Yep. You pull the door open and step into the bright white light beyond. And you emerge into the hallway holding a gold medallion.
Hip hip hooray.
What I get for being showy.
What the hell is in
so
there?
So you see now
He hasn't we haven't
So now Conti, now that everybody's out there, I'll point out that so Boaz is wearing his steel medallion. It has three outlines of stars. Your medallion is bronze. It has one filled star and two outlines of stars.
Oh man.
And Schmendrix is gold and has three filled in stars. Mm. And you can see that each has a single word in Urien on the bottom. Boaz says failure.
Naturally.
Schmendrix says victory. And yours says participation.
For fuck's sake.
As soon as I see...
It doesn't translate quite that cleanly, but it's something like, you tried.
As soon as I see Schmendrick's medal, I'm going to take mine off and just kind of toss it.
Okay.
I like how you called it a participation trophy at the beginning, too.
Yeah.
As soon as the medal strikes the floor, it shimmers and then vanishes.
All right, well, there's one more setting if you guys want to try it, I think.
I'm almost tempted to try that one. After you guys describe
it. I get my hit points back, right?
Yes. You feel fine.
I feel
Schmendrick, you have not expended a spell slot.
Okay. Same for Boaz?
That was a cantrip.
If you use one.
Same for Boaz. I think it was just a cantrip, though, yeah.
I turned the dial.
The third one was... Two cross swords.
That's right.
So I'm guessing that's sparring.
I'm going
in.
So you open.
I'll let the two contestants go in
and step out into what essentially resembles the dojo from the Matrix.
Who hasn't gone actually?
Me.
Okay.
Yeah. The diving suit.
I don't think the diving suit cares. Does the diving suit care? I'm really curious about that.
So wait, who's going in?
Altum went in, I think.
Boaz at Altum.
Yeah, I go in.
Okay. So as you guys step out,
I'll go in
this...
too.
Great. So as you all, apparently, is anybody not going?
I'm not.
I'll stay out this time.
Yeah.
Okay. So
I'm pretty ashamed at, like, okay. I'm sorry, but Schmendrick, who's our cleric in armor, just beat me at a stealth check.
Well,
I am forever shamed.
So, you don't.
He wasn't wearing armor inside the room, though.
I know, but like
he was wearing the same rough spun clothing.
The holy man beat the rogue.
You were basically dressed like prisoners.
Yeah, I as a rogue, I got beat at rogue stuff. So
yeah,
for fuck's sake.
So you step into this white space. And as you do, these weapon racks rush toward you on either side, and then they stop.
And you find yourselves... my hair flick in the wind?
Yes. Awesome. Dramatically. You find yourself standing in the middle of like this like Costco of weaponry, essentially. And there's every kind of bladed and barbed implement you could possibly want.
I grab a halberd.
You see like a sword that is just on fire. All kinds of crazy nonsense.
I grab the fanciest halberd I can.
Okay.
I tie my shoes.
Do we still have like our shit on us?
No. So in this space, you are wearing what resemble monk's robes.
Do I have spells still?
Yes, you still have access to your magic.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Oh, this is going to be epic. Break out the fucking popcorn for this.
I would like to look. I would like to look for a rapier.
Wait, so, okay, so here we are.
That looks special.
Now, wait, are they facing each other? Like, not facing in battle, but are they facing each other? Are they, like, actually looking at each other in this room, or are they alone? I'm really curious about this.
I guess we'll find out.
Yeah.
No, you are all standing in the same space.
So they're combatants against each other?
No, so you're not actually like in a, you're in like a. Like
we're in a loadout room.
White space.
Yeah, we're in a loadout room.
Just,
like in the
you see, room. You see the door, and then white in all directions, yeah, and just in. Like endless sea of weapon racks.
I think
on the other guns. End. On the other end, you see no, they're not guns. It's swords because this is D&D.
I know. I'm making the reference.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the yeah. It's. The
I get it now. Yeah.
And on the other end, you see a different set of double doors that are open, and through it, it's like a portal. You see the interior of what basically looks like a dojo. Okay. And through that, actually, you see where the screens open. You see snow-capped mountains and snow drifting past.
Of course.
It's awesome.
Hey, John.
There are no cherry blossoms. What?
Do I feel like my God has blessed me?
No.
Do I have full spell slots?
You have whatever spell slots you had when you walked in the door.
Okay.
That's I'm going to try and find a cool looking rapier that looks like it's not just okay. A normal rapier.
So, as you're going down the aisles, right, they're arranged apparently by weapon type and also enchantment type. So you can get basically any combination of weapon type and damage type that you want.
Damage type.
Yeah, no, I got a pretty big spell.
So
like,
here's like all the regular weapons, right? Which are closest. It's like that's the civilized choice, right? Is to like pick up the longsword or whatever. And the next aisle over are all the flaming weapons. And the next aisle are all the frost weapons and so on.
So, enchanted weapons or not?
There's an aisle that's just everything is glowing with otherworldly holy light.
Up to you guys.
I would say you guys keep your choices to yourself until you get through.
Oh no, that's, I'm going to ask in character, enchanted weapons or not? This seems like a sparring room. Hello?
I mean, I, yeah.
Enchanted weapon, go all out?
I mean, I can't do anything with them, so, sure.
I'm asking this because I'm curious. Is there wands in there, too? Because, like, that'd be something Boaz would care about.
Yeah. But,
I got one wand. No. I point the wand of wonders at Percy.
There are not wands. That's not really the intent of this room.
Yeah, this is
okay.
Martial combat sparring.
Yeah, thing. That's what I figured.
Yeah,
and Boaz, I don't think you have your stuff on you.
Yeah, you don't have anything on you.
Oh, that's right.
And not like you really need it.
All right, I'll get a flaming slingshot.
I was gonna say, if we're gonna do enchanted, and the way I think this might work out, just yes or no, and if we are, then we should probably whisper to John what we're grabbing.
Wow, slingshot's 1d4 bludgeoning. Nice.
So you pick up the fire slingshot, and it has this nice mahogany handle and a firm leather, whatever it's called, thing. I don't know.
Bong?
I guess. Maybe? I really didn't want to say that, though.
I think that's,
I think that's the actual proper term. As you load the little projectile into it, you see it bursts into flames that do not burn your fingers.
Awesome.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm getting.
Okay. Percy walks to the far end, where all the weapons that are dripping with black unholy energy are.
Great.
So yeah, I'm grabbing one of those. I'm going to grab a halberd from there.
Okay.
I'm still excited about what it felt like to have a brain from earlier today.
Having a stomach's more weird.
If I only had a brain.
I'm going to take a great sword of psychic.
Oh, energy. God. He would have been too.
Nice. Okay.
Oh, shit. You jumped in here too?
What does that even look like?
Psychic damage?
Yeah.
So the blade looks like it has a violet web of electricity, almost like a plasma ball that's just kind of trapped within the metal.
That's awesome.
I'm gonna start jogging as far away from these three guys as possible.
Yeah, well, you gotta go through the dojo entrance first. Like, I think that's
picking it up. Oh, yeah. Not only does it have the weight of a greatsword, but it also has like a metaphorical weight. Like, it weighs on your mind to wield it.
So dumb.
Love it.
Hey, it's amazing. Doing its best, man. All right. Okay, so you guys step out into the dojo.
I'm typing something real quick.
Probably to you.
Everybody's going to see. The weapons are obvious in what they do. They all have like visual flares that identify them, so there's no need for secrecy here.
But yeah, I sent my thing. I'm good.
Oh, okay. So, sure. So you pick up those various products. God damn it. So you see Percy walk out here with a rapier that is oozing this black energy, as well as a flaming dagger and another dagger that looks a lot like the greatsword, but smaller. Obviously. Like the other end of the spectrum for long, sharp things. Okay. I guess we should step into the dojo.
I'm so glad this is happening.
So as you step in, you hear a gong ring, and the doors close behind you.
Dun, 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 dun.
So how many of you are there? Who all? I forgot.
I think there's four of us, right?
I know Percy's here.
Percy, Boaz, Altum, and Conti's not here.
Diving. Oh, Conti's not here.
Boaz.
Conti and Schmendrick are not here. Everybody else is.
I really wish there was a way for you guys to watch.
But I didn't bring the bell in.
Okay. Oh man, I'm not even sure how it would cope with you, to be honest. I think this is something that it wasn't really prepared for, but.
Just play that in the background the whole time on the loop.
What is that?
Mortal Kombat.
Yes.
You said a gong. You said a gong goes, and it instantly Mortal Kombat.
Oh, he's totally doing it too. It's amazing.
This is Mortal Kombat song has like a Freudian effect on my brain.
Yeah.
I know, you see red.
Boaz, I'm looking forward to your combat the most, I'm honestly.
Fucked.
Why are you completely out of? I'm not gonna ask.
Is that working?
No, yeah, it's working. It's totally working.
Oh God. Anyway, all right.
You can still
use funny. Like I started with the Matrix and we ended up on Mortal Kombat. Whatever.
I think my armor class is broken again. Broken again.
Why?
Okay. So, Alter's in here. Percy is in here.
No.
Boaz is in here. Is that everybody?
Yep.
Studded leather's plus two, right?
Yes. Okay. So Conti and Schmendrick are sitting out.
Yes.
All right. So you guys, it is up to you what you guys want to do in this space, but I might recommend rolling initiative.
Oh, Jesus.
I got to check my AC real quick. I don't know if it got fucked up again.
You should have it.
Go into the audience area or something.
Yeah. So, if you want to, you can step through without picking up a weapon.
Oh,
okay.
Totally going to do that.
And I mean, even if you do pick one up, you could just stand off to the side and choose not to fight.
Yeah. No, yeah, that's. I totally want to do that.
You see, there is an old man wearing robes who is the one who rang the gong, and he holds his hand up with four fingers extended and says, "Four combatants, free for all. Fight!"
That was amazing!
So, roll initiative?
Roll initiative.
Yeah.
Yep. I'm me and Schmendrick are in there, like, sitting off to the side watching. I'm just, like, on the ground, like, just sitting there cross-legged. My tail's around me. I'm just kind of, like, leaning back and forth, a huge shit-eating grin on my face. Like, all right. Oh my god, this is gonna be epic.
I guess I should position you guys a little more evenly. That's good enough. Okay.
Well, if anyone wanted PvP, here you go.
Yeah, Percy, you're up first.
God, can you imagine if our other, if the Wildland guys got this? Oh my god.
I just want to say, what the fuck is with our initiative?
I know. Yeah.
John, at any point in between last session and this session, did we take a short rest?
You guys are all at full health.
Oh, so we did take a short rest?
As you step into this place, you heal up.
Okay, the answer is no. About, no, we did not short rest.
What about, like, ability?
Oh, I'm sorry. You're talking about, like, external. No. That never happened. Actually, no, I'm sorry. There was when he... No, because he didn't go and get it. Never mind. Yep. He was going to go get the bowl.
Okay,
right?
So which I didn't do. Restored to full, but do our abilities come back, too?
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, which ability?
Just everybody go ahead and take a long rest. It's fine.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Just go ahead and do it.
Boaz is like, yes!
Alright.
That is the intent of this place.
Fight at your
back. Well, will it go back? Or you go back?
Do we need to remember?
No, it's not important. There's, you know.
Okay.
Woot. My turn, though, right?
Like, meta, but it's already 10:30, so.
Yeah, it's your turn, Percy.
Oh, yeah, it's Percy's up first. Yep. What are you going to do?
I knew it.
Okay. So, also, all PvP rules are enabled in this. So, who are you casting suggestion on?
The diving suit.
Oh, shit.
All right. I believe
fight with
make
me.
A wisdom save.
Actually, wait.
Oh. Fight with me?
Fight with me, yeah. I'm going to have to move closer first. So I'm going to start running into the middle. Get in range.
Oh.
And then cast it, yeah.
Just...
15.
The DC
is 15.
Okay, so what happens?
Why do you have it set to output a spell card instead of your save DC?
I don't have a... It's not an attack, I just dump the card out.
No, I know, but it should show your save DC.
Oh, I don't know why it doesn't.
Oh, all
right. Right.
But your save DC is 15?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, that is.
I'm suggesting you fight with
me. I have independently verified.
Yeah, so you fight everybody else but him.
So the suggestion is fight with me. You must follow the instruction, but you're free to interpret that however you like.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is your action.
Wait, oh.
What's the suggestion?
The suggestion is fight with me.
Okay.
From
person. Oh.
I'll fight with you.
Oh, that's amazing.
Phrasing.
Yeah, phrasing.
It's the only way I can say, you know.
Well, because he doesn't understand. He doesn't, like, I have to. The way I have to talk to him is, like, you know, feeling, right?
I like the idea that he takes it super literally and is like, okay, I'll fight you.
I understand common. What?
Oh, wait. So does. Because I thought he didn't understand common, the like, only way we could.
No, he understands common.
Oh, so it's only from him that we.
I understand common. Like, yeah, I cannot.
He can't speak it.
Oh well, then I'm gonna fucking tell him to team up with me then.
I don't know.
I'll leave it up to you.
Retconny.
I wish it would have stuck. Yeah, so, that.
Yeah, wait, so I guess that's yeah, whatever.
What did he say?
Nah, fuck it, fuck it.
He said team up with me.
Okay.
By the way, it's a concentration spell.
Yep.
It's a concentration. It's like whether or not this is last.
So that was your action. What is your bonus action, and are you going to move again?
And that's my action, and I am...
How far did you move?
30. No, 20.
Sorry. 20, so you have 10 feet left.
So you've got 10 left and a bonus action.
I'm going to... Yeah, this seems dumb. I'm gonna move here.
Okay. At least you're not in line with Alto. Action.
Yes or no?
Wait, what?
Do you have a bonus action? Yes or no?
No, that's it.
Okay, Boaz, you're up.
Boaz is up. Okay. Oh man.
Nuke him.
Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna run up here.
Now he's in line.
I'm gonna lightning.
Counterspell.
Is that reaction?
Yep.
Yeah. So I don't. Yeah,
it just nullifies it instantly.
Well, what level are you casting it at? I think matters. Or what level it is matters.
It's a level 3 spell.
I'm not sure how that would work because counterspells. Oh no, counterspells are level 3, so I think it.
You attempt to interrupt a creature in the process of casting. Yeah, third level or lower.
Yeah.
Casting a spell fourth level or higher, make an ability check.
Yeah, I would have to make an ability check. If it was
10 plus
level.
The spell's level. Yeah, I'll go ahead and do it at a higher level. Okay. Well, because I'm gonna die probably in one turn, so I gotta do something.
I'll give it to him.
So I think the way counterspell works is if it's a higher level, it automatically succeeds. If it's equal or lower, then
if it's equal or lower
or something like that.
If the counterspell is, if I cast counterspell at third level, and the spell is third or lower, it just works.
Right.
If I cast it at a higher level spell, I have to make an ability check for it to work.
Oh.
No, that's not right. Well, anyway, it doesn't matter. Is it the same level or lower?
Well, I thought
I want to cast it at fourth level.
I was like,
so yes. Okay.
He didn't say he was going to cast it at fourth. He said he was just going to cast it.
Great, so you're going to cast Counterspell.
Before you even let me cast it, you said you cast Counterspell.
Oh my god. So you cast Counterspell, fourth level. Okay, what is the level of the spell you're counterspelling?
He's casting.
Here, let me... Can I do the roll?
Yeah, for this? Do the roll.
Okay, sure.
There we go. That's the roll.
Sixth level.
No, that's just damage, the sixth.
No, yeah, okay. That's one extra d6 on top of it.
Yeah. Well, it might be canceled out, Alton.
Okay, what level did you cast the spell at?
Fourth,
Dan.
Fourth level.
It's and a fourth level lightning bolt.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, no, so the DC equals 10 plus the spell's level, so it's a DC 14.
Percy, if you're using Counterspell, you need to make a Charisma check.
That's what I'm trying to say.
A 14. Are you casting Counterspell?
Yeah. That's, I was trying to look what I had to roll.
Level. That's only true if you cast
Charisma.
It at a lower level.
You're making a Charisma check.
If you cast it at a higher level, that's why I'm asking what the level of the spell is.
Charisma.
Because you're telling me this level of the wrong freaking spell. I'm asking about the level of the counterspell, and you keep telling
me
the level
of the lightning
bolt.
I cast it at
level
3.
That's not what I'm asking. Okay, thank you. 3. That was the number I was looking for. All right, so you resist it.
Well, it gets canceled out.
Yeah.
So Alto doesn't have to take any damage.
Yeah. Great. So that was your action?
Yeah.
You've got a bonus and a move?
My bonus action is I'm going to flip off Percy.
Okay. Ultim is up.
I'm totally expecting to get stabbed in the back.
Yep.
I just wonder which one of you is Scorpion. Oh, it's definitely the diving suit. What's up? Get over here.
For the weapons we picked up, what do you want us to do for that?
What's the weapon?
I picked up one of those necrotic unholy halberds.
So I believe you were looking for something specific.
You just said that there were like unholy looking weapons, and I picked one of those up.
Right, but you were looking for a vampiric rapier.
No, that was me.
Oh, that was you. Percy. Damn it, God.
Yeah, that's why I'm asking. I don't know. Do you want me to just roll my?
So go ahead and roll a regular attack. Let's see if it hits first.
Sorry, that's just the.
23. Definitely fucking hits.
That definitely hits. Okay. So it normally does what, a d10?
It would have done 13 damage with my roll.
Right.
With a regular halberd. So add whatever you need.
No,
to
it's
that.
It's not a regular halberd though, man. It's magic.
Right, right. I get that. I'm just saying a regular halberd would have been 13 damage.
Correct. Correct. But more importantly, it's 1d10, which is what I was looking for.
Okay.
So add 1d10 necrotic damage.
Okay.
Rip. 2.
Well, hang on. I'm going to channel divinity. And add that in.
So, yeah, rip.
So that'll
35.
How does Touch of Death
41?
Work? Does it just work?
It's a channel event. It's my channel. So I channel my energy, and I deal extra damage when I hit with melee
attack.
It's a
spell attack. You got a 21.
Yeah.
Oh, the 21's not the damage. It's
No. That is the damage. It's a channel.
Wait, what?
And so the way that... Here, I'll post it.
Oh, it's like a smite. You hit, you deal extra damage.
When I hit with a melee attack, I can use my channel to deal extra
necrotic damage. But it does a d20 plus 5?
No, it does 5 plus twice my cleric level.
Good lord.
Yeah.
Okay, so you did what? How much? 14 plus 2 plus 21 plus 6. That much.
43?
I am not that good at math.
Yeah, 43.
Who'd you hit?
Percy. Me.
All right, you're down to 7.
43 total, right?
Yeah.
43. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. yeah. Okay. Ultim, was that your whole turn?
Yeah. I don't have a bonus.
Diving suit, you're up.
So, I just want to get make sure I have the right kind of weapon. We could take like basically any type that we wanted, right?
Yes.
Like, including pluses, ones, and stuff?
Right.
Okay. And then how much extra damage does it deal because it's psychic?
They're all d10.
Okay. Roll 20.
So it's going to do... if it hits, it'll do a d10 psychic damage on top of its regular damage.
Okay. I guess I'll just use my greatsword for this turn and get it set up before my next turn. Okay, I am going to
Boaz or Altum.
What? What did you say? I am going to
boil him, mash him, stick him in a stew.
Cast True Strike on Altum. And then Altum's being really dumb right now. Just keeps on locking up.
Oh, also, Percy, make a concentration check.
Oh, yeah. Thank you for reminding me. I was like, oh, shit, yeah, that's right.
Poor Percy.
Constitution
right?
Save, yeah.
Save or check?
I think it's a save.
Somebody check.
I'll check real quick.
Actually, it doesn't matter. They would both. I don't have a modifier for either.
Okay.
Yeah. And it has
Constitution
to,
saving throw.
It has to.
Yeah, it's a con save.
I'm gonna leave it up to. I have to get at least half right, which I can't do. So is it just I have to roll a natural 20, possibly? I can't match it.
You have to beat half the damage that was done to you. Right?
Yep.
Well, I guess we'll see.
Yeah, you can roll under because you get your bonuses.
I don't have bonuses.
Oh.
Did you have advantage on that?
Warcaster, yeah.
15, not enough.
Nope. So
okay, diving
suit,
you
are
not
under
the effects of suggestion.
Finish it. Percy or Altum.
But you do know that suggestion was cast on you.
Yep.
Yeah, so I'm going to cast True Strike on Altum. So my first attack against him next turn is dealt with advantage.
Oof.
And then I'm going to come up here and stab Percy.
This is not good. This is not good.
Yeah, you're running out of other people for to get fucked up.
And then a D10 psychic on top of that.
Okay.
At least the guy that can stop your spells.
Oh, shit.
As you slice through him, his body just like anime slides in half and then explodes into a shower of light.
It was very spectacular.
The particles reform over here. Percy, you're at full health again.
What?
Oh, it's one of those.
You now have two heart symbols hovering above your head.
Fight.
What?
That's great.
Percy. It's your turn.
What?
What?
Alright.
I'm just sitting there like, oh, this gets better and better.
You get to watch Percy time multiple times.
I know, yeah. Right? Holy
shit. Can't Jim be here?
That had to have fucking stung. Yeah, Jim would probably... No, Jim would hate this.
You're dying over and over.
I don't know. Jim might enjoy making everyone else die for once.
Right?
Well, shit, that didn't work. Polymorph. T-Rex.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh no.
Saw that coming.
Yeah.
He's getting polymorphed.
I'm expecting two T-Rexes in a bit.
Yeah. I mean, no, definitely not. What do you mean?
But yeah. I'm polymorphed into a T-Rex.
Move?
And
watch me turn you into a T-Rex. No, seriously though, I'm gonna give you an actual token.
So everyone knows.
A bonus action or a move?
10:45.
I'm gonna wait for you to change the thing before I start moving him.
This fight is not gonna end before 11:30.
No.
I have no idea how to resolve this.
We can just pretend.
This is so much BS. I'm just going to say that it represents... Nope, not Alton. That's not right. Where the hell is Percy? Oh. Okay. See if you can move the T-Rex.
I went.
No! It dropped out of the freaking turn order.
It's 22. But yeah, I'm just going to move back there and I'm going to stay there.
Okay.
For now.
Boaz, you're up.
As a T-Rex.
I cast Polymorph.
Are you doing the same thing?
Yeah.
I want to high-five Boaz as a T-Rex.
And, what's my movement? Let's see.
Give me 1 second. I have to do some shenanigans.
Does anybody here remember that Jurassic Park Mortal Kombat game way back when?
No.
What?
No. What?
Are you talking about Primal Rage?
Yes. There was a Jurassic Park version of it back in the day.
Percy, what is my movement?
I don't know. I'm looking it up.
Oh, let me pull it up. Oh god, but I can't because that's not an actual T-Rex anymore. Your move 50 feet. Is 50.
Okay.
Chomp.
I'm going to bite Altum.
Isn't polymorph an action?
Yeah, I was like, that's why.
Oh, it is!
Yeah, I was like, that's why I didn't do anything. I was like,
so you can move, and that's it. Altum, you're up.
No, okay.
Oh, sorry. I guess
no, that's fine. No, go ahead.
Do you have any bonus actions as a T-Rex?
No, it just has...
Because you can't cast spells as a T-Rex.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
It has multi-attack. It makes two, one with the bite, one with tail. It can't make it against the same target.
I wouldn't have moved if I had known that, but I already moved my token.
Oh, well, you can move back.
I understand.
His two more... Okay. He has three lives. He's okay.
It's literally entirely up to you, but okay. Altum, your turn.
Diving suit and Boaz need to make charisma saving throws.
Oh my god, is that like Shmendrick's, like, spirit guardians?
No.
Oh crap, I just closed my... Oh man, why? Hold on. I gotta see what my charisma is.
No, that's my character set over the
Diving
car.
Suit is frightened of me until the end of my next turn.
So let's do...
Ow.
I don't know how the fuck that works, but...
So there are now two... full-size Tyrannosauruses stomping around in this dojo, as well as some kind of demon guy.
Boaz is also frightened of me until the end of my next turn.
Okay.
I am. So you guys cannot move closer to him, and I think something has disadvantage.
Cannot willingly move closer to the source of its fear. Yep. And it has disadvantage on ability checks and attack rolls while the source of its fear is within line of sight.
Right. Okay, diving suit.
I'm going to... As soon as roll 20 stops ignoring me, I'm going to throw my harpoon at Alton with advantage. Oh, that already hit the
hole. That'll hit.
I get a crit.
Disadvantage.
Oh, I guess it just balances out. I guess I had advantage and disadvantage, so it just balances out.
Oh, yeah, true strike,
why would he have
right.
disadvantage?
Because
he's frightened of me, and I'm within his sight.
The diving suit also failed the save?
Yep.
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
Oh, it was... Oh, sorry, I put it
on. Yeah, anyway, that hits.
Eight damage. I put the frightened token on the wrong person.
And then I'm going to use my bonus action to recall the harpoon and throw it again. This time it's like, with disadvantage. I already rolled one, so I'll just roll one more time.
Are you using your regular harpoon, or did you pick up an enchanted harpoon?
I did not pick up an enchanted harpoon. Maybe I should have. I didn't think of it.
The harpoon department.
Does a 14 hit you?
Miss. Okay. God damn it, Conti.
What?
Fucking Michael Jackson.
Oh, dude, that's totally me right now. I am freaking giddy at this. This is hilarious.
Okay, that's diving suit's turn. Percy.
I'm learning so much.
Prexy?
Percy, you're up.
Perksy?
He's doing stuff.
No, I'm saying Perksy, like testing out the name. You know, T-Rex Percy? Perksy?
Perky?
P-Rex. It's also his rapper name.
God.
I mean, he is a bard.
Right?
God damn it. I just want,
you can move
I,
in range of Boaz.
Yeah, I know.
And you can high-five him. With want... claws in his face.
Okay. That's it. Oh wait, I can dash, can't I?
Yep.
Shit.
What's happening? Are you having trouble steering that dinosaur?
Yes.
Just rampaging across the...
The larger...
See, the old man next to the gong kind of, like, steps out of the way as the giant foot tearing up the floor.
Yep, so I got enough movement if I dash. I'm just going to run the fuck behind them.
Sandwich between
T-Rex. Hell yeah.
Flanking!
So, regular attack on me?
Ultim's in a rough spot.
Oh no, I had to dash.
Well,
I had to dash.
I don't think. I actually don't think in this case it would be.
None of you get flanking from this because none of you are allies.
Are allies? Yeah.
Also, we're not doing flanking in this game.
True.
Yeah.
All right. I guess that's Boaz's turn.
All right. So I'm gonna bite.
Bite who?
Do you want me to roll that since I have a T-Rex?
Sure.
All right. So let me just go ahead and.
What's I should up? Probably say that I have a hard stop at 11:30 tonight.
Okay. I mean, I assumed we would definitely be done by then anyway.
I hope so.
All right, that's in half an hour, so.
I'm going to bite.
How much speed do T-Rexes have?
I'm going to bite diving suit.
139. You guys It'll do a lot of damage per round, though. So you're doing a bite?
Yep.
It'll be disadvantaged.
A diving suit?
It's as long as I'm within range of you, anything, any ability score or attack roll.
Well, as long as he's in sight, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I said.
Well, he can cover much range. Either way.
Yeah. Anyways.
Yeah, this advantage for a different reason.
So he's doing a bite. I'm on 227s, so that'll work.
Fucking nerds. I don't need your disadvantage.
Holy
50
ball.
Piercing.
Then you're gonna...
this is why I'm not worried about it taking very long. You guys do a lot of damage.
Yeah, we have three lives. I get a second attack, don't I? Or no?
You gotta. You have the option for a second attack, but you have to attack. Ultim.
Oh, I may have described that not well. You have a hollow heart symbol and a filled-in heart symbol above your heads.
Oh,
can I? Can I bite again, or do I have to do tail?
You have to do tail, and it has to be an
Ultim. Okay, I'll tail Ultim. Disadvantage.
Actually, that's only true for Percy. The rest of you have two lives still. Okay, you're doing the tail attack.
Yeah.
That's also disadvantage.
Yeah.
13.
13's misses. Bad.
Okay. And that is both your attacks?
Yeah, but I'm going to wink at Percy.
Nice. Okay, Ultim. I like that half of you are Tyrannosauruses.
This is glorious.
I'm so glad that you guys didn't just leave.
I regret fighting you diving suit. I'm sorry.
Why? Schmendrick, what do you think of this? You gotta be sitting there and die laughing, too.
Wait. What was that? Long gone?
Oh, fuck, it didn't... God, why didn't it send my damn spell date? It's DC. I'm banishing you, Percy. Or trying to.
I'm trying to hold on to my helmet as T-Rexes pound around the place.
Right?
You had to beat a DC 15 charisma, Percy.
This one might be interesting.
This is going to be very interesting. I'm just going to roll a D20 and it's -1.
Okay.
Because I have to use the T-Rexes.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh God!
I don't believe you can cast. I don't believe you can cast that spell as a T-Rex.
He's
no,
not.
No.
He's not. Altum's Altum casting it. Altum is casting it on the T-Rex.
Oh. Well, why did you say you had to use the T-Rex stats? I'm confused.
Because I had to make a charisma save.
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha.
So Percy is banished.
Bye, Percy.
Okay.
How does that work?
You pop out of existence. And
no, wait. Hold. I'm reading the spell.
Okay.
Does this actually make me go away permanently?
You're banished to a harmless demiplane.
Yep. While I'm there. I'm there until the spell ends, I guess.
You pop out of existence, and there's like a wobbly feeling that you get of just being like torn apart, but not in a painful way. It's like you're just falling apart, and just little shards of light spilling out of you, and then you find yourself sitting on the sidelines, along with the other two.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
If the target is native to a different plane of existence than the one you're on, target is banished with a faint popping sound, returning to its home plane.
Correct.
So he's just appearing on the sidelines here?
Yep. Shouldn't he be?
Okay.
Okay.
You're making some interesting assumptions about what plane you're on right now.
Yeah.
I'm just asking.
I'll
go ahead and tell you. You are still on the prime material plane.
Well, then why doesn't he go to a different plane?
He because got magic. Banished to a demiplane, and then this thing yanked him back. If you want to know,
yeah.
Okay.
Am I still T-Rex, and do I still have
planes
one empty and one full heart?
Planes work in a strange way in Shadow Realm. That's something you guys haven't explored much. Because as soon as I gave you a plane or a ship, you burned it up. So, you know, we'll find out someday how these things work.
That person also jumped in a hole with a dragon.
In the meantime, Percy is effectively knocked out of the realm.
And the word "you" is used pretty liberally around here.
The southernmost one is Percy.
I was gonna say, like, I need to figure out which dinosaur is Percy so I can remove
the purple one.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
So that's going to be Diving Suit's turn. How did you guys get out of order? I think it should be Boaz's turn next.
Right? No, Diving Suit goes after.
It should be Diving Suit.
Yeah.
Altum just went.
Boaz have a 21?
Boaz had a 21. It was 22, 21, 2019.
Boaz is already gone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It should
be. Oh, I'm stupid. Yeah.
Yeah.
21 does not come after 20.
It probably would have been easier to just leave my thing there and then just move the thing and just skip me.
I'm attacking the T-Rex.
Vicious Psychic Greatsword.
That's one.
So vicious.
You're not frightened anymore?
No, it's until the end of Altum's next turn and his turn's ended.
Yeah. Sorry, they're not frightened anymore.
So assuming that this is working correctly.
Yep, so that should be 18.
It does look like it's working correctly.
Let me change my hit point. I forgot to change my hit points.
So that's 18 points of damage.
Oh, cool.
Four of which are psychic, if that matters.
I'm going to wait till he does all the damage.
17. Who are you attacking?
The T-Rex.
Okay.
Do I have an AC? Yeah, okay.
That also hits. Your AC is 13.
Okay.
That one is 39. 12 plus 9 is 30. Is not 31. It's 21.
Right, but total. 39 total.
Oh, that's a weird thing to have said.
Well, Boaz said he was waiting until you're done attacking, so.
But I am not. I'm using my action surge.
Well then.
Do all the things.
That hits.
Yep.
I don't even know what.
I love the name of that thing.
18.
Flaming, raging, poisoning sword of doom.
We're at 57 currently.
That's also a hit. 4 for 4.
I have a plus 7. Rolling a less
so you
than
got
13.
78.
You got 4 9s, 2 12s.
Should be 78.
See,
you don't have 2 14s. You have 1 14.
Oh yeah, 1 14.
You can't really be mad if you're defeated by a sword that's called Siegebreaker.
Sorry, how much damage was that?
It's not updating, but I did it on my thing.
78 total.
78.
I should have 61 hit points.
Oh, you should have 58 hit points.
58.
It's too bad I can only do that one.
136.
Oh, well, it was 136? Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
That was 139.
So you are at 58 hit points, and it's your turn. And he looks visibly bloodied.
Yeah, but, like, as soon as he dies and goes back to his normal form, he can just cast Polymorph again, can't he?
Maybe.
I mean, if you do enough damage on top of whatever takes him out of Polymorph, then that's...
So I'm gonna bite diving suit.
Yeah, but, like... Yeah.
Some buggy, any buggy.
What?
He's biting diving suit.
John. Gone.
All right, jeez.
Stop eating.
Is it disadvantage?
No.
No. That's over.
I'm
gonna say, fuck you, Craig.
And it is
30
grapples
of damage.
Escape.
Which knocks him out.
Yeah, that does knock me out.
Okay.
Then I'm gonna tail alt him.
So, okay. You respawn over here?
Hi. Yeah. Like I was saying, you can't really be mad getting defeated by a sword called Siegebreaker or anything like that.
That hits.
You can be mad getting defeated by a sword called, like, the Pink Tickler or something like that.
I don't think anyone here has a sword called Siegebreaker. 18 bludgeoning damage.
No, but I'm just saying, it's like, that's the idea of cool sword names.
Oh, I see.
Like, yeah!
It removes the sting.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Wonga needs to roll a concentration check.
Yep.
Oh, yep.
For what?
Did we say that was constitution save?
For banishment.
It's a con save. Oh, wait, what?
Yeah, banishment. If he drops concentration, I pop back in.
Oh, interesting. I did not know that.
That's automated.
All right.
But yeah, he totally passed. So I'm still gone. He has to do six rounds before I'm permanently gone.
You're just hanging out as a dinosaur.
Yep, I'm just hanging out as a dinosaur somewhere.
And everybody else sees you standing to the side as a ghost dinosaur.
Yep, I'm just standing there.
Licking my teeth. So it's now Alton's turn.
And no, once the spell ends, 808, you pop back into existence where you were.
Yep.
Correct.
Which I'm kind of keeping track of.
Oh, good.
Okay, my turn.
Actually, where were you?
I was,
he was
right
just
there.
South. Yeah, right, he was here? Centered right here.
I was centered right there.
How many hit points did you have?
Full.
He was full.
Full?
Yeah. Okay. I didn't get to do anything.
Alright, I'm going to put you on the GM layer.
You got winked at?
I totally got winked at. I tried to give you a thumbs up. I don't know if it worked.
You don't have any thumbs, so.
Oh.
That looks like a hit.
Okay.
13.
13 damage?
Hang on a sec, sorry. During it, once you can deal extra draconic damage, one attack or spell. You're going to take 21 damage.
Why, though?
my necrotic shroud.
Yeah, but why, though?
But why, though?
I mean, I will, but why though?
And then I heal 6.
But why though? Wait, why?
Vampiric touch.
But why did? Yeah. Why is it 21, not 22?
No, 22 is the hit.
No, why is it 21 and not 13?
Because of my necrotic shroud, I can add my level in necrotic damage to spells or attacks I hit with.
Oh, it's like an item.
Oh, is that not already in there?
Okay. No. Sorry.
Alright, I did it. I don't think it's registering correctly on my hit bar, but I'm registering. I got 40 HP left.
Yeah, I can't see the hit bar. But
sorry, how much is it supposed to be to you? How much damage is it?
21 damage to him.
I already...
Okay, so you should be at 37.
What?
You're a 58.
58.
And that is my turn. I think, yeah.
There's not something wrong with that math, is there?
No.
Okay. Okay, diving suit.
I'm going to use my bonus action to call my harpoon, and then I'm going to cast Chromatic Orb on the T-Rex.
Okay.
The uncool man.
Oh shit! And you crit.
There.
That's amazing.
It's cold damage.
26.
Wow.
26 points of cold damage.
Okay.
Still in the fight.
I guess I'll go ahead and apply that since it's not working for you for some reason. So you're down to 11.
Yeah.
Buy it out.
Okay.
A single tear cascades down my cheek.
You have a turn on the other plane. No. Do you do anything?
No, he's incapacitated.
Oh, he's incapacitated?
Yep.
Oh, all right.
So, John, when I respond, all my HP came back, but not, like, my abilities that I can use.
Just your health.
Just your health.
Okay. Yeah. I can't, like, prepare anything on the other plane. I'm just there.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to bite Altum Brown.
I bet he tastes delicious.
I bet he probably tastes like awesome. Hell.
I mean, right now,
oh,
maybe.
Right, sorry. I keep forgetting that I have to roll for you.
I don't want to say it forcefully.
Sorry. That's a hit.
There we go.
And 22 piercing damage for the bite. And I'm assuming the tail is also against him.
I can't do that, I don't think.
You get
does he also need to make that DC 17 save?
Yep. Oh, we can't make both attacks against the same target. Oh, I see. Yep.
What is the DC 17 against, though? Like, what am I rolling?
To escape, you're grappled.
Strength. Right, okay.
Strength. Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, damn it.
Fuck's good. That should actually be a strength roll, not a strength save. But 19 is plenty.
Oh, yeah, sorry. No. It's the same either way. I'm not proficient.
Oh, okay.
Then I'm gonna charge at diving suit, even though it's gonna kill me.
I will take my reaction.
Go for it. And I say, end me, daddy, as I run.
Wait, 15 hits?
13 points of damage.
Yeah, it's not hard to hit the dinosaur.
A little bit more.
So you.
I mean, I'm dead.
Well, just you're not dead, though.
Yeah, you just returned to being a little...
So you go back to being a gnome. And then
that's
you
hilarious.
Take the excess damage. So, okay. You had 11 hit points. How much has it done?
It did 19 total.
Wait, don't I go...
So you take 8 points of damage as a gnome.
Wait, hold
which
on.
Means you still have 3.
Wait.
What?
You only have 11 HP total?
I know, I had 50. I had full health. When I polymorphed.
Yeah, he didn't take
any
damage.
Oh, you've been
yet.
Subtracting from your own hit points.
Yeah. So I could keep track.
Alright, hang on, let me set you up. So your full is 50? Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So,
so you take 8 points of spillover and okay, so you're at 42.
Altum also needs to make a con check.
4.
Concentration.
Banishment.
Oh, yep.
You don't think he's going to forget about that, do you?
I constantly forget about that.
I forget about it because, yeah.
That doesn't look like enough.
He took 22.
Half. It's on half.
He matches.
He took 20 points. Is that enough?
That should. I think he just needs the match, not exceed.
Oh my god, that's so close. Okay. All right. let me add Boaz's turn back in. So you still have your bonus action. I don't know what the hell you're... 21, right?
Yeah.
Bonus action. Whew.
Yeah, you've got a bonus action, and I guess your movement's probably used up.
Can I hellish rebuke this bitch for necrotic striking me?
Yeah, sure.
That'd be a reaction.
That did happen after he turned back into a gnome.
Yeah. Well, it spilled over into it, so I'll say because took damage.
He took 12 damage, that turned him back into a gnome, and then he did Divine Strike.
That's what we're saying. Yeah, the damage spilled over into his other form.
Yeah, no, I'm saying the Divine Strike happened after he reverted back into
it. It
happens all at once.
It's all part of one attack.
Yeah.
So it's not like
it's simultaneous.
Then. Yeah.
It's like Smite.
I thought Smite happened one and then the other.
No.
You roll them in that order, but they happen at the same time.
In my mind, I've always seen it as like you stab them and then you choose to like electrify your sword with radiance.
Oh, no. That's just a mechanical thing.
Well, because can't you decide whether you want to do Smite or not after you've made the attack?
It varies by DM.
Oh, okay.
I don't actually know what the raw rules are. Anyway, so that is a dex save needed by Alton, I guess.
Yeah, I know. We'll be done by 11:30.
Barely.
10 minutes later, we've just now gotten Boaz out of the
That's a hell of a fail. Storm. Okay, so you take damage, and now you need to make another con save. So you take 9 points of fire damage. your spell ends.
Welcome back to the world.
Oh god, I can just see this happening too. It's amazing.
That's my turn.
What did the 9 points of damage take you down to?
I'm at 16.
Okay. It's your turn, though.
Yep.
Run away!
He's gonna banish me again.
Could you imagine?
No, I can't, actually. I'm out of fourth levels.
So at this point, Boaz hasn't died, and Altum hasn't died.
Yep.
Percy hasn't. Oh, yeah.
Percy I did.
You both died at least once.
I died very quickly.
Yeah, but now you've been, like, sitting off on the sidelines, resting, holding onto your health while everybody else beat the shit out of each other.
Yep.
Awesome. Come on. We have limited time.
Yep. Yeah,
sorry, I'm trying to find it in my list of fucking things.
What is it?
That.
Okay.
Guiding bolt.
That die is cocked AF, saying.
Not on my screen.
No, I mean,
that thing is totally.
It was like balanced between like six different D6s.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Oh
yeah.
That's definitely a hit.
Who are you targeting?
Boaz, I assume.
Oh, okay.
You gotta say this stuff before you roll.
Yeah. Sorry.
Because otherwise, people could, like, and roll and meta. Choose a target based on how they
do. Yeah, and there's another 8, so it's 22 total.
Oh.
Because necrotic trap.
Yep.
What? So can you... Oh, we'll talk later.
And that makes it so the next person to attack him has advantage, right?
Yeah.
Or is it everybody until your next turn?
I think that makes it the Diving Suit's turn.
One attack.
Was that right?
I'll look it up while you're doing it.
Is Alton's turn done?
Yes.
Okay. Diving suit. Take us home.
I'm going to stab Boaz.
Yeah, it's one attack.
So one attack has advantage?
25. That's so sad. Yeah, that hits.
Man, my...
We have a shish kebab little gnome.
I wonder if you can do 20 points of damage.
You for sure can.
With a vicious psychic greatsword.
Nope.
No, apparently not.
Well, he has more attacks.
I have one more attack.
13 points of damage?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And this is not with advantage, right?
Right.
The guiding boldness has been used up.
Oh!
Critical
fail. Wow! Alright.
Crit fail!
I gain 100 health.
Yeah. Turn back into a T-Rex.
Percy's turn.
Bite Altum.
Move so that you can tail Boaz.
T-Rex, you have to fight the other T-Rex.
Move so that you can tail Boaz.
I can move in between them.
I know, I'm just saying. Bite me and tail Boaz. Make it fucking even. Go.
You're gonna send him flying. It's amazing.
But yes. Also, yeah, I am totally bite. You gotta roll.
Yeah.
Should I roll it?
Yeah. I don't have a thing, so yes.
Who are you biting Altum?
I'm biting Altum.
Yes, he's biting me.
Okay, and that's normal.
So, 23. 13.
Oh, that's a 23.
I'm dead.
22 person. 22. Damage. Okay. So you have now died as well, Altum?
Yes.
As the teeth into you, you hear another gong, and the old man has rung the gong, and he steps forward and presents a gold medal to Boaz.
Here's your medal, Boaz.
I scream.
Oh, I didn't get to finish my turn.
Nope.
Ran out of time.
As soon as all of you
time limit up.
As soon as everyone except one person has died, the match ends.
Nice.
I'm the fucking champion.
Very nice.
This is congratulations.
I am going to drop polymorph and high five Boaz.
IRL, bro.
That is why fighters doing 8 attacks on one turn is still no match for a wizard.
You hear another and you are now standing in the hallway again.
Oh, that was super entertaining. Thanks, guys.
Oh, and sorry, I dropped my little shroud thing, too.
Okay. I'm sure you guys have lost track of your spells and health and all this stuff.
I kept it all.
Oh, really?
What do you mean lost track?
From what it was before we went in there?
Yeah, lost track of what you had before you went in. I mean, if you were keeping track of it, oh well, it's not relevant. So, for sake of time, what are you guys going to do in broad strokes now that you're out of the experience?
We're going to go check the on our way to the red door.
Yeah.
So you're going to backtrack to go back to where the red door was?
Or did somebody want to?
I can't think of anything else to do here.
Yeah, I was like,
no.
Open all the doors, see where they lead.
Okay. Well, you've got
where I could
17 more locked doors in this room. But
oh no,
you're pretty sure they're all bedrooms.
Yeah.
Probably for the sorts of people who, in another life, would have made lock picking YouTube channels. Let's go ahead and call it.
Yeah.
Right there. So you have found your way from the top to the bottom of Talon Rest. You've figured out how to open the windows, which is nice. You've discovered this bizarre holodeck bullshit. and you found the way out into the main hall.
Awesome.
Feel like that's quite an accomplishment.
Yeah.
So I will wear my gold medal around my neck.
Oh, and also, it's sundown now.
Oh.
Like after sunset, sundown?
Like it's sunset.
Oh.
The sun is just setting.
Oh, I'm pulling the book out.
Okay.
No one stopping him.
What? Why did we stop him?
I don't know. I'm just asking.
So where are you guys? Because you have to be able to see the sunlight.
I assume Boaz ran to the front gates.
All right. Are the rest of you following with him?
I'm walking towards the front gate, but yeah, he ran in front. So I'm not.
I think Schmendrick's done for now. He's just gonna get out of here.
Okay. As you guys are heading out into the, I'm assuming you're heading back to the inn. In the center of town, Boaz snaps open the book and the pages begin to turn themselves. And that's where we'll cut it.
Oh, great.
Yay!
So I guess we need to do scheduling. Yeah. Whee! Everybody's favorite.
Coming back to a fight with no spell slots again. Yay!
I need to figure out when Mother's Day is.
May.
Is it May?
It's the 4th.
May 13th.
Is it really May 4th?
No.
No.
I was like, really? Double if your mom's a Star Wars fan.
Oh, that's
exactly.
I feel like there's gotta be a your mom joke in there somewhere, but I can't find it.
Your mom has midichlorians.
Oh, that's that hurts.
That's pretty rough. Okay, God. So I'm going to be taking that weekend to go visit my mom, for hopefully obvious reasons.
Well, that's a couple of weeks from now.
Yeah, so I just wanted to make sure that that wasn't the next one. So next weekend, I think, is...
We got Wildlands.
We got Wildlands on the 28th.
I thought Wildlands was on the 5th.
So,
why do I have that written down?
Why is it on day view now? Week. Come on, week view. Oh my god.
So just jumping in here. It won't matter too much because of the whole Mother's Day thing. Well, I guess it kind of does. I will be gone from, I think, the 5th until the 13th.
Mm. Okay, so we can't do the 5th then, which would be the next... two Saturdays from now.
It's, I think it's the 5th.
So we could...
I need to double check on that. We might be able to do
that. That also would block out the 9th, which would be the next Wednesday. That's good for us.
Right. I mean, I can try to make it. I just can't guarantee it because I'm going to be out of town.
Nah, that's
think
fine.
You're better than us?
yes.
So.
Fair enough.
He's not wrong.
Fair enough.
So, in that case, we could either do, like, this Saturday.
Nope.
Okay.
Nope. So, was Wildlands scheduled for the 5th?
Wildlands right now is scheduled for the 5th. Okay. It sounds like Altum can't do that.
Yeah.
It's a maybe. I need to double check. I can't remember what day we're leaving on.
Okay, so let's leave that one in place for now, I guess, and then just let us know. Yeah. So what about the 9th you will be somewhere, you'll be out of town?
Yes, the 9th I will be in a hotel room.
Okay.
Never stopped any, John.
He'd never stopped me from running it, but maybe it should have.
I mean, I can't
granted, you ran a game from a fucking airplane. Like,
that was so stupid. That was such a terrible idea.
I know.
It was, I mean, I had fun, but I don't think anybody else did.
I can double check and see if the hotel room I'm in is separate rooms. I can't remember.
Oh, yeah. I was just joking.
Let's not.
Some of the hotels were separate rooms.
I would say that it looks like we're going to have to take a couple of weeks of break.
Mm-hmm.
Given the scheduling conflicts. So let's go ahead and pick either the 19th or the 23rd. The 19th is a Saturday. The 23rd is supposedly a good Wednesday.
Let me just confirm. See, the 2nd is bad. Yeah, 23rd should be good.
Okay.
So do we have no games this weekend?
That is correct.
Yeah.
I have it listed as busy. That's why on the schedule, I was just like, oh.
Phil, are you busy this Saturday?
Yeah,
is that...
I'm going to be in Chicago.
Oh, right. Okay. Of course.
Oh, you're not terribly far from me. That's funny.
Is there a way to rename stuff on the calendar, personally?
I don't know.
Because they all just say busy, and I don't know which game's which.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They should show. Hmm.
Wait, there's a calendar?
Yeah. Yeah, there's a Google calendar.
Where is it?
Here.
If you go into the FAQ, it's in there.
There you go.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's weird.
And it just says busy on like that's why I got confused too. Is like this past.
By default, this event will follow the sharing settings of this calendar. Event details will be visible to anyone who can see the details. Okay, so let me try to fix this. Settings and sharing.
So there's going to be no D&D for like
ever
a month.
A month. A little bit less. Sucks.
You mean like lead normal lives?
Speak for yourself.
Yeah.
I just won't have to rush everywhere after work for like a little while.
Oh my god.
I still will, but it won't matter.
All right, I think I actually have to add you guys to the calendar to share that information. That's weird. So, okay, I'm gonna need email addresses.
That's okay.
For anybody who wants to actually see information.
I just wait until someone messages me and say, hey, D&D.
But you were on earlier today.
Yeah. Does anybody got here before I did.
Want me to send this to their email?
Yeah.
I certainly do not.
Okay.
Yeah, not at the moment. Maybe
I'll
later.
I'll never check it anyway.
I check my mail way too fucking often.
Okay.
5 minutes later.
There you
wait,
go.
Was I supposed to do?
Well, I guess.
I sent you the thingy. I got so much shit going on, like, every day I gotta keep track.
Okay.
Pretty sure I did that right.
Yeah.
So we're gonna go with the 19th, right? Tentatively.
Why can't I show you all event details? What the hell?
I think the 19th is a solid date. The 5th is tentative.
That sounds right.
Oh, so tentative for the 5th.
Yes, okay. It's mm-hmm. just based on what day I'm actually leaving.
Okay. Is that going to be Wildlands, though?
Yes.
Should be.
Yeah.
Typically, Saturday games are Wildlands, I think.
Yeah.
Tommy is just weeping silently in the background.
For some reason, calendar won't let me send. It won't let me show anything except free busy. I can't figure out why.
Reasons.
That's weird.
It's really annoying. Calendar. Security.
I'm glad we decided to test out those other settings on the dial.
Yeah.
Yeah, what did you guys think of the stuff today?
That was very different. That was awesome.
I'm disappointed.
I'm so mad that I lost the prison break.
I'm disappointed I even get to participate.
Aw.
We'll have to do it again. Because I'm that's a challenge for me to actually get that right.
If it's any consolation, there's actually more stuff to find there.
Oh, nice. Wait, like
there's
in that area?
There's also two other halls.
Oh, all right.
This is just the Raven Nest.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I still don't like the door.
I've said too much.
I love the door. It's awesome.
Yeah, that was an interesting little detail that I never in a million years thought would become relevant, and then he just happened to mm-hmm.
worship the Raven Mother.
That first one that we walked in, that me and Percy got raffle stomped in is, wow. Hey!
that the room was horrible.
I'm going to have to go in there and, like, actually stealth it out in something, because I'm curious. Horrifically curious.
Point.
Okay, I can't figure this out. I'll just deal with it later.
I was like, I'm looking through the settings, like, I have no idea what the fuck to do.
So, I think... either, like I said, either the 19th or the 23rd.